Who is ready to go with me to a journey today? Yes. Hallelujah. Since we're releasing something significant to the world, let me start with a prayer. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, shehechiyanu v'kiyemanu v'higiyanu lazman hazeh. Amen. Amen. Let's bring the first slide on, if you don't mind.
Empecemos con la primera diapositiva.
And you're going to have to click a couple of times to do it. Yes, you're going to have to bring the full slide. And for those who are running, let me just say, please make sure when we bring the slide, I'll tell you to bring one point at a time. But it's really an honor and a joy to be here.
Es un honor y una honra estar aquí hoy día.
For this adventure that we're about to take together.
Por este evento que está a punto de suceder.
In the next few hours, we're going to launch worldwide the sidur that call Ahavat Olam.
En la próxima hora, las próximas horas, vamos a lanzar el sidur.
This is the most significant work that we have ever released since the return of the kosher pig.
Esta es la obra más importante que hemos sacado desde la edición de el retorno del marrano
kosher.
Kosher.
First, we're releasing this in English.
Primero lo vamos a sacar en inglés.
And the week after Sukkot, it will be available in Spanish as well.
Y una semana más tarde de Sukkot va a estar en español.
But before we start this journey together,
pero antes de que empecemos esta travesía juntos,
next slide. Some people ask who we are.
Algunas personas preguntan quiénes somos.
I'm the founder of an organization called, if you don't mind to click, yes, thank you. Ahavat Amin.
Soy el padre de una organización llamada Ahavat Amin.
And we produce, just similar to what El Shaddai does, we produce messages and a word about the Torah to the world.
Hacemos algo similar a lo que El Shaddai hace. Llevamos a Torah al mundo.
As we operate in two areas.
Y estamos abiertos en dos áreas.
Among the Jewish people.
Una para la población judía.
And upon the nations.
Y para las naciones.
To see this reconciliation. Pardon? To see this reconciliation.
Oh, para buscando la reconciliación de estos dos.
I told you this morning.
Les dije esta mañana.
That you are significant.
Que ustedes son significativos.
The wholeness of the house of Israel is depending upon what we are going to do.
La toda la casa de Israel depende de lo que vamos a hacer.
Consider the story of Joseph and his brothers.
Consideren la historia de José y sus hermanos.
Everybody wants to focus on the reconciliation between Joseph and his brothers.
Todos quieren enfocarse en la reconciliación de José y sus hermanos.
But that is a mistake.
Pero ese es un error.
Because when Joseph
porque cuando José
revealed himself to his brothers,
se revela a sus hermanos,
he said the three words.
Él dice tres palabras.
In Hebrew,
en hebreo,
Ahod,
Ahod,
Avi,
Avi,
Chai.
Chai.
Is my father still alive?
¿Está mi padre aún vivo?
Well, who was Joseph's father?
¿Dónde, quién era el padre de José?
His name is Jacob.
Su padre era Jacob.
Jacob's name is Israel.
El nombre de Jacob es Israel.
Joseph is the Messiah.
José es el Mesías.
Jacob is Israel.
Jacob es Israel.
And the brothers are responsible for the reconciliation between Israel.
Y los hermanos son responsables entre la reconciliación de Israel
and the Messiah.
Y el Mesías.
Who are the brothers in the story?
¿Quiénes son los hermanos en esta historia?
Our rabbis tell us that the brothers in the story.
Los rabinos nos dicen que los hermanos de la historia.
Is none other than the nations.
No son otros más que las naciones.
Are you following what I'm telling you?
¿Me entienden esto lo que les estoy
diciendo? But the nations gone alone, they go to Joseph and he has not revealed himself.
Pero las naciones han ido a José y él no se ha revelado.
But when Benjamin came,
pero cuando Benjamín vino,
when Benjamin joined them,
cuando Benjamín se unió a ellos,
right then he revealed himself.
Ahí en ese momento él se reveló a ellos.
Who is Benjamin in this story?
¿Quién es Benjamín en esta historia?
Benjamin is critical.
Benjamín es crítico.
And the rest of the brothers are critical.
Y el resto de los hermanos también son puntos críticos.
Benjamin and Joseph,
Benjamín y José,
are like God and Reuben.
Son como Dios y Rubén.
Messianic Jews,
judíos mesiánicos,
and messianic Gentiles.
Y gentiles mesiánicos, mesiánicos gentiles.
Yes. Caleb,
sí,
and Joshua.
Caleb y Josué.
Us marching together.
Mientras nosotros caminamos juntos.
To find Yeshua, and give me a siddur, please. If
para encontrar a Yeshua.
Us marching together to finding Yeshua is why we are here today.
Mientras caminamos juntos para encontrar a Yeshua es por lo que estamos aquí hoy día.
Today in this time decoding the Jewish siddur.
Hoy es el día en que tenemos que decodizar el sedur judío.
We are seeking something better than just understanding the Hebrew language.
Estamos buscando algo mucho más profundo que solo entender el hebreo idioma.
We are seeking the reconciliation.
Estamos buscando la reconciliación.
Between Israel and Yeshua.
Entre Israel y Yeshua.
I'm the founder of, if you don't mind to put the slides back, JJ. I'm the founder, and some people ask me, of which organization, Shuvu.tv.
Soy el fundador de la organización Shuvu.
This organization works now in 50 different countries.
Esta organización está en 50 países diferentes.
For one purpose.
¿Con qué propósito?
To train the nations.
Para entrenar a las naciones.
How to walk together with the Jewish people.
Cómo caminar junto al lado de el pueblo judío.
To find the real Joseph.
Para encontrar al verdadero José.
To find the real Messiah.
Para encontrar al verdadero Mesías.
So that we will be able to reconcile him with the entire house of Israel.
Para que podamos tener la habilidad de reconciliarnos con toda la con todo Israel.
We have a journey to take together.
Tenemos una travesía que tomar
when
juntos.
Benjamin go alone, he will not get the job done.
Cuando Benjamín se va solo no va a hacer
when
el trabajo.
When the brothers went alone, they didn't get the job done.
Cuando los hermanos fueron solo no lo pudieron hacer.
Today is one of the most important days maybe of my life.
Hoy día es quizá uno de los días más importantes en mi vida.
Because I can for the first time ever.
Porque por primera vez en mi vida.
Can give a tool to the nations.
Puedo darle una herramienta a las naciones.
To return back.
Para regresar.
In a minute it will become clear to you.
En un momento va a ser muy claro para ustedes.
How can a siddur, a prayer book, be such a valuable tool?
¿Cómo es que un siddur, un libro de oración, puede ser un libro tan válido?
Let me make it clear, it's not about a siddur.
Déjenme que les aclare, no es acerca del siddur.
It's about your journey.
Es acerca de tu travesía,
it's
de tu
about
viaje.
Your journey.
Es acerca de tu viaje.
To find Yeshua.
Para encontrar a Yeshua.
Together with me.
Junto conmigo.
A Jew and a Gentile together discover him.
Un judío y un gentil.
And awakening the heavens.
Descubriéndolo.
So that he will say, I want to return back to Israel.
Despertando el cielo y decir, yo quiero regresar a Israel.
We are fulfilling prophecy here.
Estamos cumpliendo profecía aquí.
Here is the next 3 hours will be very intensive.
Estas tres próximas horas van a ser muy
very
intensas.
Challenging on you.
Muy
maybe you get angry.
Un reto muy grande para ustedes.
Maybe you get upset.
Molesten. A lo mejor se van a fastidiar.
Good.
Ooh.
Because in the last segment,
porque en el último segmento,
I'm going to let you take all your anger and frustration out.
Les voy a dejar que suelten todas sus frustraciones y todos sus fastidios.
We're going to have a public Q&A session.
Vamos a tener un Q&A.
You should know this Q&A, questions and answers.
Oh, preguntas y respuestas de todos para que.
And I heard El Shaddai provide tomatoes in the back. Here is what we're going to do today. Next slide, please.
Esto es lo que vamos a hacer hoy día.
By the way, for all my friends from El Shaddai,
por si acaso, para todos mis amigos de El Shaddai,
El Shaddai ministry will be the only place in the world.
El ministerio de El Shaddai va a ser el único lugar en el mundo
where you can get this study notes completely free of charge.
donde pueden obtener servir completamente gratis.
So if this is your family,
so is your su familia.
That means that you are my family.
Oh, significa que tú eres mi familia.
So you can start calling to the office Monday morning and get the full study notes.
Entonces pueden empezar a llamar el lunes y pedir las so todas las notas de sadit.
You don't have to do that.
No tienes que hacer.
I will bless you with this.
Les voy a bendecir con eso.
Some of the greatest revelation that God has given me as a messianic Jewish rabbi.
Una de las revelaciones más grandes que Dios me ha dado como judío mesiánico.
Question number one. Oh, number one. Here's our journey. Are you ready? Number one.
Pregunta número uno.
As we are decoding the Jewish Siddur, I want you to ask yourself the question.
Mientras estamos decodificando el Siddur judío, quiero que se haga esa pregunta.
Why decoding the Jewish Siddur is prophetic step in the Geulah, in furthering the redemption today?
¿Por qué decodificar el Siddur judío es profético para entrar en Geulah?
Step number two.
Número dos.
What is the connection between the Siddur project to the event that Paul called the fullness of the Gentiles?
Número dos, la conexión entre, ¿cuál es la conexión entre el proyecto de Siddur para la plenitud de las naciones?
Now everybody should know we should not be able to decode the entire Siddur here today.
Ustedes pueden podrán entender de que no puedo decodizar todo el Siddur esta noche.
Well, we'd need a week.
Necesitaríamos una semana.
Instead, what we're going to do today,
en lugar lo que vamos a hacer hoy día,
we have a special surprise for you.
Tenemos una sorpresa muy especial.
The Siddur was produced also on an audio version.
El Siddur también ha sido producido en una versión de audición.
Because you know the Torah is never to be read.
Porque la Torá no no se debía de leer.
It is to be sung.
Se debía decir.
Why?
¿Por qué?
Because the word of God has a melody.
Porque la palabra de Dios tiene una melodía.
It is the spirit.
Es el espíritu.
When Yeshua said you are not to miss any jot or any tittle from the Torah.
Cuando Yeshua dijo no debes de perder de una ayuda o una tittle de la Torah.
He's speaking about the musical notes.
Él está hablando de notas musicales.
God loves music.
A Dios le encanta la música.
So a cantor working in our organization.
Entonces, trabajando en la organización.
Named Peter.
Vino Pedro.
He produced a magnificent melodic pieces.
Oh, es un cantor que vino a nuestra organización y ha producido unas melodías, pero increíbles.
Of the entire Siddur.
De todo el Siddur.
It's full of the Spirit of God.
Está completamente lleno del Espíritu de Dios.
Today you're going to hear five of those pieces.
Hoy día vas a escuchar cinco de estas piezas.
And more than education.
Más que educación.
I pray today.
Yo oro hoy día.
That the God of Israel touch you in a way you've never been touched before.
Para que Israel te toque una forma que nunca te ha tocado antes.
May you be touched today.
Que tú seas tocado.
The first time I heard those melodies.
Cuando la primera vez que escuché estas melodías.
And I understand the connection to Yeshua.
Y encontré esa conexión con Yeshua.
It was never the same.
Ya nunca fue más igual.
May it never be the same to
ya
you
nunca
as well.
Seré más igual.
So in step three we are going to decode five prayers.
Entonces como en el step 3 vamos a decodizar cinco oraciones.
And then we're going to let you ask anything you want.
Y después les voy a dejar que hagan todas las preguntas que deseen.
If you don't mind going to the next slide. You can get it in Amazon.
Pueden obtenerlo en Amazon.
As of today.
A partir de hoy día.
We are top number one right now.
So estamos en el número uno.
Praise be to God.
En Amazon.
I'm glad because people are learning about God.
Estoy alegre porque Dios está aprendiendo acerca de Dios.
But you should know that nobody have the Siddur in their hand.
Pero no tienen el Siddur en sus manos todavía nadie.
The first people who will get the Siddur in their hand.
Los primeros que van a recibir el Siddur, que pueden tener el Siddur en sus manos,
friends and family in El Shaddai ministries.
Son mi familia y mis amigos de El Shaddai.
So it's released publicly here today, tonight.
Entonces es lanzado públicamente aquí hoy día, esta noche.
The worship experience, 2 CDs, and the Sidur will be
released. La experiencia de alabanza, 2 CDs y el Sidur.
If you order in Amazon, expect some delays.
Y si lo ordenan por Amazon, esperen algo tarde.
Who is ready to decode the Sidur with me right now?
¿Quién está listo para decodizar el
Sidur? Are we excited?
¿Están emocionados?
I'm telling you, this is something special.
Esto es algo muy especial.
And if you think I do this for sensationalism,
¿ustedes creen que yo hago esto por sensacionalismo?
I challenge you to check everything I wrote.
Les reto que chequen cada palabra que he escrito.
I will start with the thesis.
Yo lo empezaré con una tesis.
Yeshua is in every word and every page of this Sidur that every Jew read.
Yeshua es en cada palabra y en cada página de este Sidur.
Our job in the last days,
nuestra obra en los últimos días, nuestro trabajo,
is in every page of this Sidur.
Está en cada página de este Sidur.
Every prayer in the Shabbat Sidur is messianic. Every single one.
Cada oración en el Sidur es mesiánico. Cada una de las oraciones.
But I want to start with the question why. Let's go to the next slide, JJ.
Y voy a empezar con la
and here is the question I want you to think about before we jump to the details.
Y esa es la pregunta en la que quiero que piensen antes de que entremos en los detalles.
Why decoding the Jewish Sidur is the most important action that you need to take in the last days?
¿Por qué descodificar el judío Sidur es la acción más importante que necesitas tomar hoy día?
Allow me to start this, to answer this question.
Voy a empezar respondiendo esta pregunta.
With Rav Shaul, Apostle Paul. Next slide.
Con Rav Shaul, el apóstol Pablo.
He says in Romans 11.
En Romanos 11 dice,
for which God formerly concealed, but has now revealed.
Porque lo que Dios antes ocultó, pero ahora ha revelado.
So that you won't imagine you know more than you actually do.
Para que no te imagines que sabes más de lo que realmente sabes.
It is that stoniness to a degree has come upon Israel.
Es a cierto grado esta dureza que ha llegado sobre Israel.
And I want to highlight the word for you to a degree. Israel is not completely blind, not completely.
Y quiero recalcar aquí la palabra a cierto grado. Israel no está completamente ciego.
And here it's why this is a prophetic time and a season.
Y aquí es por lo que este es un momento profético en la estación.
Listen to Rav Shaul, brothers.
Escuchen al Rabí Shaul.
I want you to understand the truth.
Hermanos, quiero que entiendan esta verdad.
Until the Gentiles world enter its in its fullness.
Hasta que en el mundo de los gentiles entre en su plenitud.
Until the fullness of the nations.
Hasta que la plenitud de las naciones.
Does not take place.
No entre a su lugar.
The fullness of the Jews cannot take place.
La plenitud de los judíos no van a entrar tampoco.
I wasn't joking when I talked to you today about the journey that the nations, that the church taking right now.
No estaba bromeándoles cuando yo les estaba hablando hoy día acerca de esta travesía que las naciones y los judíos tienen que hacer hoy en día.
If Christians worldwide stop dragging their feet.
Los cristianos deben alrededor del mundo deben de parar de estar arrastrando los pies.
And they will move just a little bit faster.
Y si se movieran un poquito más rápido.
That is the key for the salvation. The salvation will come to the house of Israel.
Esa es la clave de la salvación para la salvación de Israel también.
Please understand that Paul does not use expression that found nowhere.
Por favor entiendan, Pablo no está usando una expresión que no conocemos. Está hablando de la plenitud de las naciones que es encontrado en el libro de Génesis en el capítulo 49.
Allow me to explain to you what the fullness looked like.
Permítame que les explique cómo la plenitud se asimila, se ve.
People think that the fullness have to do with having churches filled.
La gente piensa que la plenitud es tener una iglesia ahí permanente.
Yet the Bible speaks about a remnant.
Pero la Biblia habla de un remanente.
It doesn't make sense.
No tiene sentido.
If you have remnant,
tú tienes un remanente.
You cannot have fullness.
No tienes plenitud.
You cannot have fullness if you have a remnant. They cannot work because fullness is completion and remnant is a portion.
No puedes tener plenitud si tienes un remanente, porque la plenitud es completa, pero el remanente es solamente una parte.
Fullness have nothing to do with quantity.
La plenitud no tiene nada que ver con la cantidad.
Fullness have to do with quality.
Plenitud tiene que ver con calidad.
And even in this Torah portion this week.
Y en esta, la porción de Torah de esta semana.
In Numbers chapter 30.
En Números 33.
God is telling Moses, take 1,000.
Dios le está diciendo a Moisés, toma 1,000.
From each tribe.
De cada tribu.
That's exactly 12,000.
Es exactamente 12,000.
Remember, there are 600,000 Israelites.
Recuerden, 600,000 israelíes.
If you take 12,000,
y él tomó 12,000,
divided by 600,000,
dividido por 600,000,
you get the number 2%.
Tú obtienes el número de 2%.
God says in the Torah portion, only 1/50 will go forward.
Dios dice en la porción de Torah, solo uno de
1/50.
Uno de cada 50 irán.
In Romans 11:16.
En Romanos 11:16.
Paul says that if the first fruit is holy, if the first fruit is holy.
If the Pablo dice que si el primer fruto es santo.
So will be the entire house.
También toda la casa lo será.
The word that Paul used.
La palabra que Pablo usa.
Remember, Paul is a rabbi.
Recuerden, Pablo es un rabino.
It's 2%, 1/50.
El 2% sobre 1/50.
We don't need every Christian in the world to believe this as we believe. It's a mistake.
No necesitamos esperar de que todos los cristianos crean en lo que creemos. Ese es un error.
2%.
Solo 2%.
That's all what we need.
Todo lo que se necesita.
So if the fullness does not speak about a number,
o sea, si la plenitud no está hablando de números,
what fullness speak about?
¿De qué está hablando?
Here it's what he's speaking about. I found a picture that I think we'll be able to show you.
Esto de lo que está hablando. Y encontré una foto que quiero mostrarles que puede mostrarles.
Go to the next slide. Here is the way I want you to think about the Geula, about the redemption.
Quiero en esta foto quiero que piensen en Geula,
the Geula or the redemption is like a bucket.
O la redención es como un balde.
And this bucket have drops going into it. Drip, drop, drip, drop.
Y en este balde las gotas caen. Drip, gota, gota, gota.
Every time a person does a good deed,
cada vez que una persona hace una cosa buena,
does it go into the bucket?
Va al balde.
Think about this carefully.
Piensen.
Yes.
Sí.
Somebody does a mitzvah.
Si alguien hace un mitzvot,
does it go to the bucket? It's
va
not a trick
al balde.
Question.
Sí o no?
Yes. Jackson, you sure about that?
¿Estás seguros?
Jackson, you say yes. Anybody says no? Anybody says no? You say no?
¿Quién dijo
you say no?
No? ¿Quién dijo no?
Come up here, holy sister. Come up here. No, come up here. Come up, come up, come up. Jackson, you come up too. Come up. Give them a hand. That's it. We're going to do the most Jewish thing right now. We're going to argue. My favorite part. Give them the microphone. Tell the Espanol uno momento.
Un momento, van a discutir.
We're going argumentano. I don't know this argument. Why do you say no? Why do you say, wait, you say yes.
Yes.
I say yes. This is what Rabbi Bernstein has taught us.
Well, what, it's like a what Rabbi Bernstein effect. Knows about anything? Sorry, Rabbi.
I hope you're watching this.
Oh, Lord.
No, one mitzvah leads to another mitzvah. You do a mitzvah, even if you don't do another mitzvah, somebody else does another mitzvah because you did a mitzvah. It's a snowball effect. It brings geulah.
So when I do a mitzvah, does it fill the bucket?
Absolutely. Okay. Well, it doesn't fill it, but it's a drop it's in the bucket.
It's a drop. Well, it helps filled. Fill it. Oh, okay. All right. Thank
but
you.
But it brings another drop. Is what I'm
saying. I got you. I got you. This chain reaction I talk about. Okay. Very good.
And why do I say no?
Yes.
Well, I think it must be Western teaching that I'm learning to let go of, but it seems to me this is good works. And
You're good. Keep on going. You're on to something good here.
Okay. And I feel that our good works are important, but that's not what this bucket is about. This bucket is about our Yeshua and coming to Yeshua. Okay.
Stay both of you here for a moment. I think you both missed the mark. That's a good moment. The Geula, it is true. It is true. That's why he says, Peter said in 2 Peter, make yourself a note, in 2 Peter chapter 3, I'm using your microphone. Uno moment. Just a second, we're back to Espanol. In 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 11 and 12, Peter asked the question, what people are you to be in the last days? And he said, you are to be people who are waiting on God. Think about the word waiting. But you are people to live godly life filled with mitzvot. That's what the text literally says. And in that, you may hasten the coming of the Lord. First of all, let me say one thing. And this is the most important thing I want you to get about this. You determine when the Geula will come, not God. Because guess what? God is ready. That's why he says, looking down from heaven, he is ready. Yeshua has been ready 2,000 years, and he is ready to return. The question is, what are the conditions for his return? So I ask the question, whether us doing a mitzvah, is that hastening his coming? And Jackson here said the answer is absolutely yes. You're only partially right, young man. It's depending what bucket you are filling. When a Gentile come and pray in the merits of the God of Israel, and he pray as the Jewish people pray, his mitzvot. If he do things, you know. I'm sorry, Muslims do a lot of mitzvot. You want to tell me that the mitzvot, the merit that they do in the name of Muhammad, fill the buckets of the house of Israel? Sorry, Jackson. Only the mitzvot are done by the name of God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob are going to this bucket. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You're not completely wrong. You just have to rectify this. The answer is here. It depends where our bucket is. What is our bucket and what we filling it? Thank you, by the way. Thank you. You may go sit down now. I lectured you enough. And here we go. This is important. I want you to understand something significant.
Quiero que entiendan algo muy significativo.
The word in Hebrew, fullness,
la palabra en hebreo para
does
plenitud,
not just mean the filling of the bucket.
Que parece que fuera simplemente llenar un balde.
What if I tell you today,
¿qué tal si les digo?
That instead of going drip, drop,
que en lugar de escuchar un drip, drip, drip,
what happened if we turn the water pressure?
¿Qué pasaría si abrimos un caño entero?
How much faster we can fill the bucket.
Podemos llenar este balde.
All of this concept of Hasidic Judaism, Hasidut.
Todo este concepto de Hasidic Judaísmo.
Believe in this concept that says you can control the stream, how fast the water flow.
Habla del control de cuánta agua puede salir de un caño.
Because it's like a merit points. It's called a merit points.
Porque es una es una contabilidad de méritos.
It's like having a little piggy bank.
Es como tener un
chanchito de ahorros. That doesn't sound good because there's no Jewish piggy bank.
Este es el tamaño de un chanchito de ahorros para los judíos.
Christians do a lot of good things. Christians do a lot of great things.
Los cristianos hacen cosas muy buenas, grandiosas.
They mean nothing.
Pero significan nada.
To the people of Israel.
Para la gente de Israel.
Because they don't do it to deposit it inside the people of Israel. Are you following what I'm telling you?
Por los depósitos que están haciendo a las personas correctas.
It's like imagine a basketball player.
Es como imaginar un jugador de basketball.
That have an A team and a B team. That have an A team and a B team. They have two teams.
Okay, que tienen dos equipos.
And the B team guy is the best player.
Y uno de ellos tiene un mejor jugador.
And when they do the reserve team plays, he's doing very well.
Y cuando tienen una reserva, están haciendo muy bien.
But they never get to play in the main game.
Pero nunca llegan a jugar en el juego más importante.
Well, it's great that he's doing so well in the backup games.
Fabuloso que están saliendo muy bien en los
But
juegos.
But who does he impact?
Pero ¿quiénes están impactando?
Nobody.
A nadie.
Nobody.
Nadie.
Today is a special day.
Hoy es un día muy especial.
Because we're giving you a way.
Porque estamos dándoles esto.
To learn how to pray.
Hoy día para que permitamos orar como Israel ora.
And to deposit all your prayer power
y para depositar todo tu poder de oración
straight into the house of Israel.
Directo a la casa de Israel.
I'm excited by this.
Estoy emocionado acerca de esto.
Because I know that you want to do those things.
Porque yo sé que tú quieres hacer estas cosas.
And if you think that I am just speaking something crazy,
y si tú piensas que yo estoy hablando una locura,
listen to Peter again.
Escuchen a Pedro.
Next slide.
Otra vez.
Since everything is going to be destroyed, Peter's saying,
Pedro
like this.
Pedro dice que todo va a ser destruido.
What kind of people should you be?
Entonces,
El Shaddai.
¿Qué clase de gente debemos de ser?
El Shaddai, what kind of people shall you be?
El Shaddai, ¿qué clase de personas debes de ser?
You should live holy.
Debes de vivir en santidad.
And godly lives.
Y una vida de santidad.
Make yourself a cross reference, just spent you to a mental note.
Hagan esta nota mental.
Romans chapter 7 verse 12.
Romanos 7, 12.
Paul says that Torah is holy.
Pablo dice la Torah es santa.
What kind of people should you be? You should live a holy and godly life. You should live a Torah life.
¿Qué clase de vida debes de vivir? Debes de vivir una vida de Torah.
As you wait for the day of the Lord.
Mientras esperas el día.
And work to hasten its coming.
Y vivir y trabajar, hacer obras para apurar su regreso. Oh no.
The W word, work. What have you done, Peter?
¿Obras? ¿Qué es eso?
Does somebody see a contradiction here in the text?
Bien, ¿alguien ve una contradicción en el
texto? If you are waiting for something,
si estás esperando por algo,
how can you hasten it?
¿Cómo puedes apurarla?
Waiting and hastening are two different things.
Esperar y apurarlo son dos cosas contrarias.
That's not what Peter means.
Eso no es lo que Pedro dice.
Do you realize that Peter here, basically, the Rambam stole from Peter?
Ustedes saben que Rambald prácticamente le robó ese pensamiento a Pedro.
Maimonides says, I believe in perfect faith.
Dice, yo creo en una fe perfecta.
In the coming of the Messiah.
En el regreso del Mesías.
And even if he will delay.
Y si ahí aún esté retrasado.
I will await him every day.
Yo esperaré por él cada día.
Doesn't it sound like Peter?
¿No suena eso como Pedro?
Yep.
Sí.
What does he mean when he say wait?
¿Qué significa cuando dice espera?
Waiting is like the word a waiter.
Esperar es como decir un mozo.
What a waiter does?
¿Qué es lo que es el mozo?
Sir, can I get you a cup of coffee?
¿Te sirve? ¿Quieres una taza de café?
Sir, can I get you something to drink or something to eat?
Señor, ¿quiere algo de tomar o algo de comer?
Wait is not what Christian thinks it's mean.
El esperar no es lo que los cristianos piensan que es. Oh, se lo espero por la
come and rapture me out of
por el arrebato.
I don't want to be here.
Yo no quiero estar aquí.
Take me, Lord.
Llévame, Señor.
This is not waiting in Hebrew, in Hebraic thought.
Esto no es esperar en hebreo, dice.
Waiting equals taking actions.
Esperar, ese tipo de esperar es como tomar retos.
Waiting mean anticipating.
Esperar es anticipar.
Waiting mean move forward in your journey. That's waiting. Waiting is anything but sitting still on your tujes.
Moverse hacia adelante, continuar, hacer algo en lugar de sentarse a esperar.
I am here to tell you before we decode this sidur.
Estoy aquí para decirles hoy día antes de que decodicemos el sidur.
And I believe El Shaddai going to spear this thing upon the nations right now.
Y yo verdaderamente creo que El Shaddai va a derramar esto sobre todas las
Can
naciones.
Can you imagine thousands, maybe tens of thousands of Gentiles praying with the name of Yeshua, the same prayers of the people of Israel?
Se pueden imaginar miles y miles de cristianos, de gente en el mundo orando el mismo sidur junto con el pueblo de Israel.
Can you imagine the spiritual power that this is going to be releasing? Are you hearing me, people of God?
Imaginar del poder espiritual que se va a soltar. ¿Se dan cuenta?
I am excited.
Estoy emocionado.
Kosher pig was a child game because we talked about theology.
El marrano kosher fue una para empezar porque hablamos de teología.
Buy it, still buy it.
Cómprelo, cómprelo.
Now we are doing something about it. We are giving you a chance to get into the game.
Entonces ahora necesitamos dando la oportunidad de entrar al juego.
Please don't buy my book.
Por favor, no compre mi libro.
If it's going to collect dust on your shelf.
Si va a colectar polvo en tu biblioteca.
Please spare yourself the $59.99.
Por favor, los $59.99.
I am the worst salesman on the face of the universe.
Sería un desperdicio.
Buy it only if you want to join the house of Israel.
Cómpralo solamente si va a unirse a la casa de
Israel. And if you are committed to pray as a Jew and learn to pray as a Jew.
Si estás comprometido a orar como un judío orar como un judío.
Each and every one of you, when you start to learn to pray for Israel with Israel,
cuando tú empiezas a orar con Israel, por Israel, con Israel,
you increase the pressure of this faucet.
Has incrementado la presión de este caño.
Are you hearing what I'm saying today?
¿Entienden hoy día?
This is not a joke now. This is not
Esto no
a joke.
Es una broma. No es una broma.
What is the connection? Next question.
¿Cuál es la conexión? La siguiente
pregunta. What is the connection between the sidur? In a second, we'll define what is a sidur.
¿Cuál es la conexión del sidur?
To the fullness of Israel and the fullness of the nations.
Para la plenitud de Israel y de las naciones.
Let's understand a couple of things about the sidur.
Entendamos cómo funciona este sidur.
Next slide. Number one. Please write yourself in your note. The word sidur is derived from the Hebrew word seder.
La palabra sidur se deriva de la palabra hebrea seder.
Seder means not seder, seder.
Seder.
Seder means order.
Que significa otro.
For example, when
orden.
We do the seder
orden.
Pesach, right? Now, what do you do when you meet for Seder Pesach, when you do the Passover?
¿Qué haces cuando haces la celebración de la Pascua y usas tu Seder?
Do you do things however you feel like doing them? No. You go from the steps of the Passover Seder, right?
Tú sigues los pasos de la Pascua.
The same thing is true about the Hebrew Sidur.
Es lo mismo es cierto acerca del seder hebreo.
Please understand that all of the siddur.
Por favor, entiendan que todo el siddur.
In one shape or another, come to resemble the temple service.
De una forma o de otra, resembla el servicio del templo.
So until the Messiah's glorious return.
Entonces hasta que esperemos el regreso del Mesías.
Israel is commanded to continue to remember the temple service, and that's what we're doing.
Israel está ordenado a recordar este servicio del templo, y por eso tenemos estas oraciones.
If it is Birkat HaShachar or the Shema.
Cantamos el Shema.
Or the Amidah.
El Amidah.
All of those prayers were there during the time of Yeshua already.
Todas esas oraciones estuvieron desde el tiempo de Yeshua.
70 AD, the temple was destroyed.
70 años después de Cristo, el templo fue destruido.
But we had to continue the temple service.
Pero continuamos el servicio del templo.
So this is what we have left with.
Y esto es lo que nos queda.
Until Yeshua's glorious
hasta
return.
Que Yeshua regrese.
Number three, I want you to recognize about Siddur.
Número dos, vamos a reconocer acerca del Siddur.
A Siddur have to be prayed with a minyan.
El Siddur tiene que ser orado con un minyan.
What do I mean by a minyan?
¿Qué significa eso del minyan?
There are certain prayers. You can pray those prayers. There's no problem on your own.
Hay ciertas oraciones y tú, no hay problema de que tú ores estas oraciones en
But Jewish
solo.
Prayer is very different than a non-Jewish prayer, beloved.
Pero las oraciones judías son muy diferentes a las no judías.
Jewish prayer, the prayers of the house of Israel, is a prayer of corporate. They are corporate prayer.
Son corporales.
And you see it in the text that 10 men have to be present to be able to say all the prayers.
Y ustedes ven en el texto que 10 hombres tienen que estar presentes para hacer las oraciones.
You can pray those prayers, but if you want to have power,
tú puedes orar esas oraciones, pero para mayor poder,
real power,
verdadero poder,
get a group of 9 men.
Reúne un grupo de 9 hombres.
Make a commitment Monday morning 6 a.m.
Los lunes en la mañana, a las 6 de la mañana.
Let's pray together.
Oremos juntos.
We have given you
hombres,
Shabbat Siddur now.
Les estamos dando
There
el Shabbat
is no reason in the world.
No hay razón en el mundo.
That El Shaddai will not have 10 men here 30 minutes before the services.
Que El Shaddai no tenga 10 hombres que para que oren a las 6 de la mañana antes del servicio.
To recite the prayers that every Jew in the world recite at the same morning.
Para que reciten estas oraciones que cada judío en el mundo lo está haciendo.
And the idea behind 10 is this: we know that not every Jew in the world pray, right?
Ustedes saben que cada judío en el mundo ora, ¿verdad?
And the reason there are 10,
y la razón de que son 10,
because those 10 are representative of the entire house of Israel.
Porque están representando la casa entera de Israel.
They are the, remember the bucket picture I showed you earlier?
¿Recuerdan el balde que les mostré, la foto?
There is a representation of the merit that is given to the house of Israel.
Esa es una representación del mérito que se le está dando a la casa de Israel.
And in Israel, we learned, the house of Israel learned, that when 10 are standing and praying, all of Israel receive merit.
Y se sabe de que cuando uno se levanta a orar por Israel, toda la casa de Israel es la recibe.
We need you to pray.
Necesitamos que tú ores.
We need you to learn to pray with us.
Necesitamos que aprendas a orar con nosotros.
We need you to learn to pray as Jews.
Necesitamos que aprendas a orar como los judíos.
Because that is your fullness.
Porque esa es tu plenitud.
And that's what adding to the house of Israel.
Y eso es entrar en la casa de Israel.
You can be the substitute player who coming into the game.
Tú puedes ser la sustancia de oración que viene al juego.
Who really wants to be part of the house of Israel?
¿Qué más quiere ser parte de la casa de Israel?
I want to see just now, are the 10 men
hay 10 hombres
who are willing to commit between now, you know, I don't like to play games.
Comprometidos a jugar, comprometidos en el momento, algo así como
are there 10 men who are willing to commit between now and Rosh Hashanah? That's 7 weeks.
Hay 10 hombres que se comprometan hoy día hasta Rosh Hashanah por
7
semanas.
30 minutes. It should not take more than 30 minutes.
Que venga 30 minutos
before service.
Antes del servicio.
And pray for the house of Israel.
A orar.
Come on, let's see 10. Como ten, la ten men
casa
hands.
De Israel.
We are Israel. We are Israel. Okay, hey, Sherry. No, I'm not joking. This is a call. This is a covenant.
Este es Sherry. Un llamado.
Sherry,
este es...
I'm not. This is not a game. Those 10 men.
Sherry, apúntalos.
Somebody can get a sign-up sheet. I am holding you responsible between now and Rosh Hashanah.
Yo los voy a contar desde ahora hasta Rosh Hashanah.
To put this into action. Praise be to God.
Para poner el sidur en acción.
I'm excited. Now I am excited.
Ahora estoy emocionado.
Now I am excited.
Ahora estoy emocionado.
Praise be to God. There will be a house of prayer for all nations here.
Alabado sea el Señor que va a ser una casa de oración por todas las naciones.
Number four.
Número cuatro.
It is a way for Israel. The Siddur is a way for Israel to connect with God and continue their priestly duties.
Es una manera para Israel que se convierta, que se conecte con Dios y continúe con su sacerdocio, deberes de sacerdocio.
But the question that we must ask ourselves in number five.
Pero la pregunta que debemos hacernos es número cinco.
Who are the authors of those prayers?
¿Quiénes son los autores de esas oraciones?
Now things are going to start getting dicey. Things are going to start to get messy. After all, it's messianic.
Ahora las cosas se van a enredar.
Why should we recite?
¿Por qué debemos estar en silencio?
A prayers by rabbis.
Las oraciones de los rabinos.
Who rejected Yeshua.
Que rechazaron a Yeshua.
Come on, let's be honest.
Sean honestos.
Why should we recite the prayers?
¿Por qué debemos recitar estas oraciones?
That are not in the scriptures. That are not in the Bible.
Que no están en la Biblia.
Rabbi Shapiro, are you returning us to Catholicism?
Rabbi Shapiro, estamos hablando de catolicismo.
Number one.
Número uno.
Every prayer that is written in this book.
Cada oración que está escrita en este libro.
Is either directly from the scriptures.
Es directamente de las escrituras.
Or based upon the scriptures.
O basadas en las escrituras.
Number two.
Número dos.
Let me give you proper introduction.
Déjeme que le dé una presentación apropiada.
To these prayers, to these men.
A estas oraciones.
Who wrote many of those prayers.
A estos hombres que escribieron muchas de estas oraciones.
Say hello, next slide.
Digan hola a.
To the men of the great assembly.
A los hombres de la gran asamblea.
How many of you heard the notion before? Those Jews, those evil, evil Jews.
Esos judíos malados.
Added to the Torah.
Añadieron a la Torah.
And they created this thing called the Oral Torah.
Y crearon esto que se llama la Torah oral.
And they violated the Torah because of that.
Y violaron a la Torah por eso.
There is a holy war right now on the internet.
Hay una guerra muy grande en el internet.
Between those messianics and Christians.
Entre mesiánicos, esos mesiánicos y los cristianos.
Who believe that the rabbis really added to the Torah.
Que creen que los rabinos añadieron a la Torah.
Do you realize how offensive it is to the Jewish people?
¿Ustedes se dan cuenta de lo ofensivo que eso es para los judíos?
If somebody hold this idea that a Jew who would take the Torah will change the Torah.
Que alguien como los judíos que veneran tanto a la Torah vayan y cambien a la Torah.
That is not the case.
Pero ese no es el caso.
Those people who said never read the Siddur, never read the prayers, they don't know what they're talking about.
Muchos que no han leído el Siddur, no han leído las oraciones, no saben de lo que están hablando.
Let's have a small history lesson.
Tengamos aquí una pequeña historia.
The men of the great assembly.
Lección de historia. Los hombres de la gran asamblea.
Were men, as you recall, Israel is returning from exile.
Son hombres de la época que Israel regresaba del exilio.
As Israel returning from exile.
Mientras Israel regresaba del exilio.
Israel forgotten what it's mean to be practicing Jews.
Israel se olvidó de lo que era ser un judío en
práctica.
Completely
forgetting.
Completamente se olvidó.
The job of the religious leaders.
El trabajo de los líderes religiosos
was to establish what's called in Hebrew takanot.
Fue establecer lo que en Hebreo dice que es lo que él dijo.
Takanot.
Takanot.
That's come from the Hebrew word tikkun.
Eso viene de la palabra tikkun.
To help people to returning to the Torah.
Ayudar a la gente que regrese a la Torah.
The Jewish people themselves forgotten the root. We've forgotten the root.
El pueblo judío se habían olvidado de sus raíces.
So we establish a takanot, a tikkun.
Entonces estableció que en el Tanakh tikkun.
And what is number two? What is the ultimate job of takanot?
El trabajo más importante del takanot.
To learn how to pray.
Aprender a leer, a orar.
To learn how to return to the Torah. That's the only job that the religious leader had. This is way before Yeshua's time. To return us to the covenants.
Aprender a cómo regresar a la Torah, regresar al pacto.
And to bring an oral understanding. Last point, to bring an oral understanding so they can transmit it down to the people.
Y traer también una interpretación oral para que se pueda transmitir a la gente.
So who are those men of the great assembly?
Entonces, ¿quién eran estos hombres de la gran asamblea?
Ezra. Nehemiah.
Nehemías.
Mordecai. Those are all the men of the great assemblies.
Los grandes hombres de la gran asamblea eran.
Please understand, we are talking about the biblical figures here.
Por favor, entiendan, estamos hablando de figuras bíblicas aquí.
And I will make a statement, and I want you to hear this statement and take it in. Next slide.
Voy a decir algo que por favor quiero que entiendan.
If one does not believe that there is oral interpretation to Moses.
Si aquel que no creo que no cree que hay una interpretación oral de la Torah hecha por Moisés.
He rejects Judaism.
Es está rechazando el judaísmo.
And by default.
Y como falta.
He rejects the historical Yeshua.
Está como defecto está rechazando al histórico Yeshua.
Please understand, when Yeshua was born, he born already to the system of Takanot.
Por favor, entienda que cuando Yeshua nació, él estaba ya en el sistema del Takanat.
When you hear Yeshua rejecting the tradition of the elders,
cuando ustedes ven que Yeshua rechazó la tradición de los ancianos,
it have nothing to do with Takanot.
No tenía nada que ver con el Takanat.
Takanot is like the law of the land.
Takanot es como la ley de la tierra.
How many of you hold the word of God?
¿Quiénes levantan la palabra de Dios?
How many of you hold the word of God above everything else? I do.
A la mismo nivel de todo el resto.
So what are the examples of Takanot that we see? What are those? Can you give me example, Rabbi Shapira?
¿Cuáles son los ejemplos de Takanot que podemos ver? ¿Me podrías dar un ejemplo, Rabbi Shapira?
Takanot again is oral interpretation.
Takanot es la interpretación oral.
That you cannot find in Moses.
Que no se puede encontrar en Moisés.
And here is the shocker.
Y aquí viene un choque.
Those Takanot.
Ambos.
Is what you and I called scriptures.
Es lo que tú y yo llamamos escrituras.
Well, what kind of example? Let's look at a few of them. Next slide. Number one.
Miremos algunos de ellos. Número uno.
Nehemiah chapter 8, declaration of the Torah, reinstitution of the Torah by Ezra. That's the first takanah.
El primero, la declaración de la Torah por Ezra.
Number two.
Número dos.
Prohibition against mixed marriages, Ezra chapter 10.
Prohibición contra los matrimonios mixtos.
Here is a hard one for you to
swallow.
Here is a hard one for you to digest.
Y acá viene uno muy difícil para digerir.
But do you know that even when we read the Bible in Hebrew, even in Hebrew,
pero tú sabes que inclusive cuando lo lees en hebreo, inclusive en hebreo,
all the 12 prophets,
todos los 12 profetas,
Ezequiel,
Daniel,
Esther,
all
of those books went through editorial.
Todos esos libros libros pasaron por una edición.
They went to editorial by the men of the great assembly. Those things we call the Bible.
Todos pasaron por, fueron editados por los grandes hombres de la gran asamblea.
Do you think Yeshua would be against that?
¿Ustedes creen que Yeshua iba a estar en contra
de eso? If he is against that, he is against the scripture.
El que está en contra de eso está en contra de las escrituras.
Oh, it's not sundown. I can't sell, I cannot buy.
No puedo vender, no puedo comprar.
Really, brother?
¿Verdad?
Can you share with me in the Torah?
¿Puedes compartir conmigo en la Torah?
Where I cannot buy and sell on the Shabbat?
¿Puedo comprar algo en el Shabbat?
I challenge each and every one of you to find a verse that says I cannot buy and sell on the Shabbat.
Los reto a cada uno de ustedes para que me muestren dónde dice que no puedo comprar algo en el Shabbat.
It does not exist.
No existe.
But it is found in the book of Nehemiah, chapter
10. Pero es encontrado en el libro de
Nehemías. Prohibition of buying and selling on the Shabbat.
Prohibición de comprar y vender en el Shabbat.
By Nehemiah. Nehemiah stated it.
Por Nehemías. Nehemías lo
because
dijo.
The men of the great assembly had passed an oral interpretation.
Porque los hombres de la gran asamblea ya lo habían pasado como interpretación.
But where did they get this interpretation from?
Pero, ¿de dónde sacaron esa interpretación?
They passed it from their fathers. And they pass it from their fathers and pass it from their fathers.
Lo pasaron de sus padres a sus padres a sus padres.
Are you hearing what I am explaining you today here?
¿Entienden lo que les estoy explicando
aquí? All interpretation is found in the Bible itself.
Toda esa interpretación está encontrada en la Biblia misma.
And in the entire New Testament. Do you know how many places in the New Testament?
¿Saben cuántos lugares en el Nuevo Testamento?
How many references are to things that are not mentioning in the Torah?
¿Cuántas referencias hay que no son mencionadas en la Torah?
In the book of Acts.
En el libro de Hechos.
It said that the disciple walked a Shabbat distance.
Dice que el discípulo caminó una distancia de Shabbat.
Where exactly does it say what a Shabbat distance is in the Torah?
¿Dónde esa distancia de Shabbat está en la Torah?
The only place it says it.
El único lugar que lo dice
is by the authors of these books.
Es por los autores de este libro.
Those who put the takanot together.
Todos aquellos que pusieron el
takanot. Please understand something. If the disciple and if Yeshua was against those takanot, he would not be able to survive even.
Entonces, por favor, entienda, Yeshua, los discípulos de Yeshua no estaban en contra del takanot.
Because that was Judaism.
Porque eso era judaísmo.
That's why it says in Pirkei Avot 1:1, next slide.
Por eso es que dice
Moses received the Torah.
Moisés recibió la Torah
and transmitted it to Joshua.
Moisés recibió la Torah de Sinaí y la transmitió a
Josué. Joshua transmitted to the elders.
Y Josué lo transmitió a sus ancianos.
And the elders to the prophets.
Y los ancianos a los profetas.
And the prophet be distributed to the men of the great assembly.
Y los profetas a los transmitieron a los hombres de las grandes asambleas.
This is about what? 300 years before Yeshua time? 300-400 years before Yeshua time?
Eso es lo que dijeron. 300 años, 300-400 años antes del tiempo de Yeshua.
Be deliberate in judgment.
Sé librado.
Raise up many disciples.
Levanta muchos discípulos.
And make offense to the Torah. Protect the
Torah.
Does anybody have any issue with those statements? Anybody have a problem with them? Yes? No? Maybe? All of Judaism is based on those three laws.
Todo el judaísmo está basado en esas tres leyes.
Please understand, when Yeshua is coming to the world, he is born into the system. He is part of this system already.
Cuando Yeshua viene, él nació dentro del sistema. Él era parte de ese sistema.
It says Moses received a transmission from God.
Moisés recibe una transmisión directa de Dios.
He received a written word and oral interpretation.
Él recibió una palabra escrita y una interpretación oral.
He passed it down to the entire house of Israel.
Él se lo pasó completamente a la casa de Israel.
We have an unbroken chain from Moses all the way to the men of the great assembly.
Y tenemos una cadena que no ha sido rota desde José hasta los hombres de la gran asamblea.
How do I know that it is true?
¿Cómo yo sé que esto es verdad?
Because my father told me so.
Porque mi padre me lo dijo.
How does my father know it's
true? ¿Cómo mi padre supo esto?
Because his father told
Porque
him
su papá
so.
Se lo dijo a él.
Do you know they found inside in Israel recently a phylactery, a tefillin?
¿Ustedes saben qué es el signo que los judíos se llevan en la cabeza?
And you know what's written inside of it?
¿Y saben lo que está escrito dentro?
The exact same thing that is written 2,000 years later.
Las mismas palabras que fueron escritas 2,000 años atrás.
Not a letter has been changed.
No, ni siquiera una letra ha sido cambiada.
Now here the word that Moses received, that's the word Kabbalah.
Aquí recibimos esta palabra, Kabbalah.
It has nothing to do with Kabbalah.
Que no tiene nada que ver con Kabbalah.
Kibel is to receive. And then he passes it down.
Y él lo recibe y luego
and
lo pasa.
Here is the problem.
Cuando hay un problema,
when he passed something down,
cuando él lo pasa
the Bible,
a alguien,
the word here in Hebrew, pass it down, is the word masar.
La palabra que se usa es masar,
which means to pass it down.
¿Qué significa pasarlo?
In the Bible, sometimes it's translated as the word tradition.
En la Biblia, a veces es una palabra que se persuade como tradición.
But there is a big distinction between the tradition that he is talking about when he rebuked.
Hay una diferencia bien grande cuando él está hablando de la tradición, cuando él reprende la tradición.
To what he's talking about here, heavenly transmission.
A lo que está hablando aquí una versión celestial.
Masoret is in heavenly transition.
Es una transición celestial del cielo.
Please don't make a distinction when Yeshua being challenging to the Pharisees.
Por favor, no haga una distinción cuando Yeshua está reprendiendo a los fariseos.
Please understand, Jewish halacha, codified law, as a whole, does not exist yet as we know it.
Por favor, entienda, halacha es una ley que no existe, una ley que no existe.
What is actually in existing is takanot, is a statutes, okay. A code of conduct. That is existing. That's what the Grand Assembly people gave us.
Lo que realmente existe es los takanot, que realmente son unos pasos, unas reglas que verdaderamente existen.
So what is Yeshua doing?
Entonces, ¿qué está haciendo Yeshua?
Yeshua is challenging the new takanot.
Yeshua está retando al
new. Now there is new kids on the block. Have you ever heard the band? The new kids on the block.
¿Recuerdan lo que cuando se dice, por ejemplo, nuevo, el chico del
Yeshua
el nuevo vecino?
Would never challenge Nehemiah, Ezra, Mordecai. He would never challenge them.
Yeshua nunca iba a refutar a Nehemiah, Ezra. Nunca él iba a hacer eso.
He is challenging these new kids on the block.
Está retando estos nuevos vecinos.
When he's talking about the tradition of the elders.
Cuando se habla de la tradición de los ancianos.
Like when he's talking about the washing of the hands.
Cuando se está hablando, por ejemplo, de la lavada de las manos.
Or healing on the Shabbat.
O en los himnos del Shabbat.
There is nothing there that he is going against the oral interpretation of Judaism. Not at all. On the contrary.
No hay nada que está yendo que vaya en contra del judaísmo. Al contrario.
We always get the sense like Yeshua is being ganged up and being challenged by every Pharisee.
Siempre tenemos la idea de que Yeshua está siendo atacado por muchos fariseos.
It's not true.
Eso no es verdad.
Because Yeshua himself.
Porque Yeshua él mismo
he's a Pharisee.
Era un fariseo.
Ladies and gentlemen, I will prove it to you today. It's an argument inside the family with a specific sect of people who want control and power.
Era una discusión entre cierto grupo de personas que querían control y poder.
So what is a masoret?
Entonces, ¿qué es el
masoret? Please learn the language today.
Por favor, aprendan el idioma.
Masoret is not tradition.
Masoret es no una tradición. No
but
es una
it's rather heavenly transmission.
Pero es una transición, una transmisión celestial.
Here is the definition of the word masoret. Next slide, it says the following.
Aquí está la
the next slide.
Definición de masoret.
Masoret is a cultural system. And I want to underline the word. No, go back. Masoret is a cultural system.
Masoret es un sistema cultural.
That includes rituals.
que incluye rituales,
opiniones, values,
valores,
set of cultural behavior,
conjunto de comportamientos culturales,
that is passed from generation to generation in a group or a society.
Que es pasado de generación en generación a un grupo o a una sociedad.
The Masoret have two aspects to it, inward and outward.
El grupo está actuando sobre el Masoret interna y exteriormente.
Jews have many Masoret.
Como judíos tenemos muchos Masoret.
Don't mix the Masoret.
No mezclen el Masoret
with the minhag. With the word minhag.
Con minhag.
You know, Jews who come from Eastern Europe.
Los judíos que vienen de Europa oriental.
When they read the Torah.
Cuando leen la Torah.
They will say Vazot Torah. They will lift up the Torah after the service.
Ellos levantan la Torah después del servicio.
The Jews who came from Spain,
los judíos que vinieron de España,
will lift the Torah and say it before they read from the Torah.
Ellos levantan la Torah y lo hacen antes del servicio.
That's called a minhag.
Eso es a minhag.
A custom.
Una costumbre.
A tradition.
Una tradición.
A tradition can be good.
Una tradición puede ser buena.
And a tradition can be bad.
O puede ser mala.
Now this is not what a masoret is.
Eso no es lo que el masoret es.
A masoret is that.
Un masoret es.
When I do the Amida prayer, standing prayer.
Cuando digo la Amida, la oración de Amida.
I am going to pray 19 benedictions.
Voy a orar 90
If I'm a Jew from Yemen. If I'm a Jew from Yemen.
Si yo soy un judío, si yo soy un judío de Yemen.
A Jew from Israel.
De Israel,
a Jew from Spain,
un judío de España,
a Jew from United States,
un judío
no matter
Estados
what
Unidos,
kind of Jew,
no interesa la clase de judío,
I'm going to pray the same prayer.
Voy a orar la misma oración.
That's called Masoret.
Eso es Masoret.
Yeshua have no problem with the Masoret.
Yeshua no tenía ningún problema con el Masoret.
He have the problem when people take tradition and they put it actually above the Masoret.
Tenía problemas con la gente que hacía tradiciones y la ponía antes o por sobre el mesoret.
I know it from my own family.
Yo lo aprendí eso en mi propia familia.
You know, we put the mezuzah.
One
time I walk into a room and I didn't kiss the mezuzah.
Una vez entré a un cuarto y no besé la mezuzah.
People look at me and say, "You see? This messianic Jew, he didn't kiss the mezuzah."
Y me miraron y decían, "¿Ya ven? Este judío mesiánico no besó la mezuza."
That's a tradition of man.
Esa es una tradición de hombre.
That's what Yeshua is speaking against. Are you hearing what I'm telling you?
De eso de lo que Yeshua está hablando.
Please understand, he is not speaking about the takanoto, the oral interpretation, like the buying and selling, the institution of the Shabbat, the Torah, Rosh Hashanah, all of those things.
Por favor, entiendan, él no estaba hablando de la Torah, de Rosh Hashanah.
Passing to somebody knowledge is one thing.
Pasar el conocimiento a otras personas es una cosa.
You know what my heart desire is?
¿Ustedes saben el deseo de mi corazón?
To pass you the Masoret.
Pasarles el Masoret.
To pass you the culture.
Pasar la cultura.
This is my desire that we will be able to achieve together.
Este es mi deseo de que tengamos la posibilidad de alcanzarlo juntos.
It's more than knowing how to pray and what to say and what not to say, but to pass the values of the house of Israel.
Es no solo pasarles la oración de cómo decirlas y para qué decirlas, sino pasarles el conocimiento y el valor con la casa de Israel.
And that is hard.
Y eso es difícil.
You are not raised up praying as Jews. You are not raised up praying as Jews.
Ustedes no han crecido orando como judíos.
A Jew pray from this book every day.
Un judío reza de este libro
todos los días. World.
Cada judío en el mundo.
This entire book has to do with the coming of the Messiah.
Este libro entero tiene que ver con todo lo del Mesías.
And he do two Torah. He's doing multiple Torah service actually.
Y se hacen muchos servicios de Torah.
You know, he's doing the there is a Shabbat day and there is a weekdays.
Hay oraciones para el Shabbat.
People think the Torah is read only in the Shabbat.
Semana.
It's not true. The Torah is read on a Monday and on a Thursday as well.
La Torah se lee todos los días.
It's resembled the temple service.
Está recordando el servicio del templo.
The Jew pray from this Jew from this book when he's born.
Los judíos, un judío reza este libro cuando nace.
And when he dies.
Y cuando muere.
Everything when he gets married.
Todo cuando se casa.
Because it represents us.
Porque nos representa a nosotros.
And if you say, who cares what us do?
Y alguien dirá, ¿y a quién le interesa lo que nosotros hacemos?
Allow me to remind you, Romans chapter 3.
Déjeme que les recuerde en Romanos capítulo 3.
What advantage does the Jew have?
El mérito que los judíos tienen.
Much in every way. Because he is the holder of the oracle of God.
Por ellos son los que guardan los oráculos de Dios.
So if we are wrong, as my father used to say to me,
como mi padre me decía,
at least we are wrong together.
Si estamos equivocados, al menos estamos equivocados juntos.
The very first thing that we know that is called a sidur that we can find, a physical copy of a sidur.
La primera cosa que sabemos donde podemos encontrar una copia física del
sidur. Is dating to the 8th century.
Está en los años 800.
I promise you that Yeshua did not walk into the synagogue.
Pero Yeshua caminando dentro de la sinagoga.
Let me turn to page 8.
A ver, voy a mirar en esa página.
Yeshua didn't do that.
Yeshua no hizo eso.
He knew the prayers.
Él sabía, conocía las oraciones.
He recited them by heart.
Él las recitaba de su corazón, de memoria.
And today I'm excited because I'm going to show you that Yeshua knew this book way better than I do.
Estoy muy emocionado, pero Yeshua sabía este libro mucho mejor de lo que yo lo conozco.
You look shocked. I'm concerned. Who are the men of Ghent Assembly?
Entonces,
we started with 120 men.
¿Quiénes son estos hombres de la gran asamblea?
That then shrink to 70 men. Then they shrink to 70 men.
Oh.
Español. 70.
Okay.
Shivim. 70. 70. Or men of the great assembly.
12, right?
No.
Okay, empezamos 70 hombres de la gran asamblea.
20. So do we see those men explicitly mentioned in the text?
Entonces, ¿estos hombres este texto?
So many times.
Tantas veces.
Let's look at a few examples quickly before we're ready to start the decoding process. Number one, I'll show you in the book of Ezra chapter 9. Go with me there.
Número uno, vamos al libro de
Ezra chapter 9 verse 1. Look at what it says.
Ezra 9 capítulo 1. Perdón,
it
capítulo
says,
9 verso 1.
When
dice,
this was over,
cuando esto terminó,
the officers approached me.
Los oficiales se acercaron a mí.
Who are those officers?
Y me dijeron, ¿quiénes son esos?
This is the book of Ezra. It's talking about the men of the great assembly.
Están hablando acerca de los hombres de la gran asamblea.
And look at the message. The people of Israel and the priests and the Levites have not separated themselves from the people of the land whose errant practices and like those who are the Canaanites, Hittites, Perizzites, Jebusites, Ammonites, the Moabites, and every other ites.
Israel y los sacerdotes y levitas no se han separado de los pueblos de la tierra cuyas
Please
abominables prácticas son como los de los cananeos, hititas, fereceos, jabuseos, amonitas, egipcios y amorreos.
Those are the good guys.
Estos son los buenos muchachos.
They're the one who fought.
Quienes pelearon.
Why I have love for Orthodox Jews?
¿Por qué tengo este amor por los judíos?
Because they are the one who were willing to give their own life to uphold the Torah.
Porque ellos son los únicos que están decididos a dar su vida por la Torah.
Let's look at another example.
Miremos ejemplos.
I told you that even the Word of God, what you as Christians call the Holy Bible.
Yo les digo que ese libro que ustedes cristianos le llaman la Santa Biblia.
And do you realize that all the Bibles are originating the Hebrew Bible? Everybody know that?
Ustedes todos saben de qué se origina en la Biblia hebrea.
The first Bible is not New King James or Old King James.
La primera Biblia no es el
It's not the NIV.
Santiago.
And it's not the Amplified Bible. And a matter of fact, I'm even going to shock you further.
Es más, le voy a dar otro choque.
Some of those books that you love.
Uno de esos esos libros que ustedes les encanta.
Let's take some of you. Who is your top who is your favorite prophet, Jackson?
Dígame, ¿quién es tu profeta favorito, Jackson?
Isaiah.
Isaías.
What is your favorite prophet, Sherry?
Sherry, ¿cuál es tu profeta?
Isaiah. Anybody here love Ezekiel?
¿Quiénes ama Ezequiel?
Come on, who love? You have all those visions of
a
chariot. How many of you love Ezekiel?
¿Quiénes aman a Ezequiel?
When we were canonizing what is known as the Bible in Hebrew, not in Hebrew.
Cuando hablamos de la Biblia en hebreo,
the rabbi says X on Ezekiel.
El rabino dijo X en Ezequiel.
They say Ezekiel is no good.
Ezequiel.
We are not including Ezekiel in the Bible.
¿Qué? ¿Vamos a anular Ezequiel de la Biblia?
Anybody know why?
¿Y saben por qué?
Anybody know why?
¿Quieren
Do you
saber
want to
sabe?
Know why?
¿Quieren saber?
You sure you want to know why?
¿Quieren saber por qué?
Okay, I'll tell you why. From the 36th chapter to the 45th chapter,
porque desde el capítulo 36 al 45,
there is a mysterious figure that appears in the book of Ezekiel.
Hay una figura misteriosa que aparece en el libro de Ezequiel.
He is called the prince.
Se llama el sacerdote.
And he's doing something very, very strange there.
Y está haciendo algo muy extraño.
Upon his arrival,
desde que él llega,
when the rabbis all agreed he's the Messiah,
donde los rabinos decían es el Mesías.
They say that he is, the scripture says he's instituting a new sacrificial system.
Dice que él instituía un sistema de sacrificio nuevo.
Very interesting, because this sacrificial system does not follow Moses' sacrificial system.
Muy interesante porque este nuevo sacrificio, sistema de sacrificio, no seguía las leyes de que Moisés había instituido para los sacrificios.
The men of the great assembly say time out.
Los hombres de la gran asamblea dijeron alto aquí.
Ezekiel is clearly a false prophet.
Ezequiel es claramente un falso profeta.
Because of that.
Por eso.
But
por
you
ese
see,
factor.
I need you to understand they had the Spirit of God.
Pero tenía el Espíritu de Dios.
Those men had the Spirit of God.
Esos hombres tenían el Espíritu de Dios.
And then they received the revelation.
Y luego recibieron esa revelación.
This is way before Yeshua. Way before Yeshua.
Esto es mucho, mucho antes de Yeshua.
They understood that the sacrifices, they are like a training sacrifices to prepare Israel.
Ellos entendían perfectamente de que había unos sacrificios como un entrenamiento para Israel.
So they say, Ezekiel is okay.
Entonces dijeron Ezequiel.
And that's how Ezekiel got into your Bible.
Está okay. Entonces por eso es que Ezequiel está en tu Biblia.
Look what it says in Hebrew, and I'm going to give you the reference. Bava Vatra 15a. The rabbis tell us.
Miren lo que dice en hebreo Batrat en en el 15.
Jeremiah wrote his own book.
Jeremías escribió su propio libro.
The book of Kings and Lamentations.
El libro de Reyes y Lamentaciones.
Ezekiah and his colleagues wrote the following.
Ezequías y sus colegas escribieron lo siguiente.
A mnemonic to remember which book they were written.
Y un mnemónico para recordar qué libros escribieron.
And there's a play of letters here. This is a little Hebrew juggling.
Y este es un juego de letras aquí.
Yud.
Yud.
For Isaiah, Yeshayahu, start with Yud.
Para Isaías.
Mem.
Mem.
Mishlei, Proverbs.
Mishlei.
Shin.
Proverbios.
Shin. Shir Hashirim, Song of Songs.
Shin, canción de canciones. Cantares.
And Ecclesiastes, Kohelet.
Y Ecclesiastes.
The members, oh my God, the members of the great assembly wrote the following.
Y los miembros de la gran asamblea escribieron lo siguiente.
They wrote Ezekiel.
Escribieron Ezequiel.
All the 12 prophets.
Todos los 12 profetas.
Daniel.
Daniel.
And the book of Esther.
Y el libro de Esther.
Ezra wrote his own book.
Ezra escribió su propio libro.
And the genealogy of the book of Chronicles until his period.
Y la genealogía del libro de Proverbios.
Beloved, I want to stress to you that Yeshua was brought up out of this environment.
Entonces Yeshua creció dentro de este ambiente.
Every time you see this text in the text, the men, the words, the officers of Judah.
Cuando uno ve estos hombres que son como oficiales de
Judá. In Ezra and Nehemiah, you know it's talking about the men of great assembly.
En Ezra y Nehemiah se está viendo es un hombre que están orando en la asamblea.
Here is another example in the book of Ezra, chapter 12. Next example.
Acá hay otro ejemplo en el libro de Ezra, capítulo 12.
It says, I had the officers of Judah go up unto the wall, and I appointed two large thanksgiving and processions.
Dice, tengo a los oficiales de Judá que vayan a la designados a...
I had to say I had to the officers. He had to submit to the religious authority of this time as the Jewish people returned to Judaism and to the Torah.
Ellos debían de someterse a los líderes y someterse a la Torah.
What is this man did? They wanted to see our people returning to Judaism. They lost their Judaism too.
¿Qué era eso? Es que ellos querían verlos regresar al judaísmo porque también habían perdido su judaísmo.
So they start to teach the people of Israel how to pray.
Entonces empezaron a enseñar al pueblo de Israel cómo orar.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is way before Yeshua time.
Damas y caballeros, esto ha sido mucho antes del tiempo de Yeshua.
I want to change the way you are thinking. The story does not start with Yeshua.
Yo sé, ustedes saben que la historia no empieza con Yeshua.
The story starts with Moses.
La historia empieza con Moisés.
All the way to the great assembly.
Todo el camino hasta la gran asamblea.
Continuing with Yeshua.
Y continúa con Yeshua.
We have to look at this environment.
Tenemos que mirar ese ambiente.
So next slide, what is the connection?
Entonces, ¿cuál es la conexión?
Between Yeshua, the messianic faith.
Entre Yeshua, la fe mesiánica.
And the prayers that written by these men.
Y las oraciones escritas por estos hombres.
Specifically, I would like to make this important statement with you.
Primeramente quisiera hacerle decirles esto.
That this is your roadmap.
Que este es tu mapa.
Remember, we are today in Parashat Masayeh, journey.
Recuerden.
This is a road map, a road guide for you.
Este es el mapa para nuestro camino.
For four things, understanding, number one, understanding the end times.
Número uno, para entender los tiempos finales.
The prayers have to do with the end times.
Las oraciones tienen mucho que ver con los tiempos finales.
Number two, the reconciliation of the Messiah with the entire house of Israel.
Con la reconciliación con el Mesías y la casa de
Israel. Number three, that's going to shock a lot of you.
Número tres,
the Jewish Siddur has a lot to say about the nations.
El Siddur judío es para las naciones.
The fullness of the nations, the fullness of the Gentiles.
La plenitud de las naciones es de los gentiles.
Do you really think that Paul made something out of nothing?
¿Ustedes realmente creen que Pablo va a hacer algo de nada?
And number four.
Número cuatro.
What does it have to say about Israel?
¿Qué se tiene que decir de Israel?
Ladies and gentlemen, next slide. It is your job. It
Damas
is your job. Bring the entire slide to decode this book.
Decodificando este libro.
Learn how to identify with our people.
Aprendan a identificarse con nuestro pueblo.
So that you know your job in the last days.
Para que tú sepas tu trabajo en el último,
it has
en los
nothing
días.
To do with the book. It has to do with your spiritual understanding. What God requires of you in the last days.
Eso no tiene nada que ver con el libro, sino que tiene que ver con tu condición espiritual en estos últimos días.
So we're going to decode the Siddur right now.
Entonces vamos a hacer la decodificación del Siddur.
I chosen 5 prayers.
He escogido 5 versos.
And I like this statement as we start. Every one of those prayers.
Cada una de esas oraciones.
Have everything to do with Yeshua.
Tiene todo que ver con Yeshua.
He's coming.
Él va a regresar.
You and I.
Y tú y yo.
And the New Testament. And the New Testament.
Y el Nuevo Testamento.
In the Siddur.
En el Siddur.
You will notice that at the very bottom of each prayer,
van a notar que al pie de cada oración,
there is commentary.
Hay comentarios.
So you will be able to read those things so you understand why this prayer is there.
Entonces pueden, van a tener la habilidad de leer y entender por qué es esta oración.
Every person that every Jew in the world would pray.
Esto es algo que cada persona y cada judío en el mundo ora.
Now here's the 5 ones. And remember, this is not Christianity.
Esto no es cristianismo.
This is not Messianic Judaism. This is Judaism.
Esto es judaísmo.
Here we go. Here's the list. Number one, we're going to go through today.
Número uno.
Is the Adon Olam.
Es el Adon Olam.
And the missing verses.
Y los versos que faltan.
Number two.
Número dos.
We're going to go through the story of Simon Peter.
Vamos a ir a través de la
historia
de Simón Pedro.
Let me say it again. The story of Simon Peter.
La historia de Simón
Pedro.
Oh yes,
the same Simon Peter from the New Testament.
Del Nuevo Testamento.
In the Jewish Siddur.
En el Siddur judío.
Nobody looks shocked. Simon Peter.
Simón Pedro.
In the Jewish Siddur.
En el Siddur judío.
The number three.
Número tres.
We're going to talk about the Geulah.
Vamos a hablar de Geulah.
The redemption.
La redención.
And the Avot Israel found in the prayer called the Avot, the fathers.
The Avot Israel in el Avot.
Number four.
Número cuatro.
We're going to see the important prayer called the Kaddish.
Vamos a ver una oración muy importante que se llama el Kaddish.
And we're going to talk about the Lord's Prayer.
Y la oración del Señor.
And number five.
Y número cinco.
Psukei de Zimra. We're going to look at Psalm 147 and the Book of Revelation.
Psukei de Zimra, Tehillim, es 147.
Anybody else is excited
libro
right
de
now?
Apocalipsis.
You're so quiet. What's going on? Are you okay? Are you excited by
¿están
this?
Emocionados? Todos están tan
this
callados.
Is a revelation.
Esto es una revelación.
A big one.
Una muy grande.
What I wanted to do for you.
De lo que quiero hacer en este momento es.
Before we discuss each one of the prayer.
Antes de discutir cada una de las
oraciones. We're going to do something prophetic. We're going to recite them together.
Vamos a hacerlas juntos.
But faith comes by hearing.
Pero fe viene de escuchar.
You're going to hear them.
Van a escucharlas.
From the CD. That was just produced.
Del CD que se ha sido producido.
Sang professionally by the cantor.
Cantado por un cantor profesional.
Are we ready to hear the first one?
The
first one called the Adon Olam.
El primero se llama el Adon Olam.
Which means the master of the universe.
Que significa el maestro de la, del universo.
Jill, let's play the first one.
Yahare ki gol ha
continue, no continue, continue. I said, go to the next slide. It together, Lord of the universe, who reigned before any creation was formed, at the time when he made all to his favor, then his name was proclaimed King, and at the end of all things, he will reign alone in awesomeness. He was, he is, and he will glorious splendor, and he is one, and no other is like him, equal to him or comparable to him, without beginning, without end. To him is all the power and strength, and he is my God, my Redeemer, who leaves the rock of my pain in the time of trouble, and he is my banner, my refuge, the portion in my cup on the day I call. In his hand I entrust my spirit, when I sleep and when I awake. And with my spirit, all my body, Adonai is mine. I feel nothing. Amen. 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 Praise be to God. You are doing something Jewish now.
Alabado sea Dios. Estás haciendo algo judío ahora.
I want you to notice something about this prayer.
Quiero que sepan que hay algo muy especial en esta oración.
The prayer mentioned that I entrust.
La oración menciona de que yo confío.
I entrust my spirit to him when I sleep and when I am awake.
Mi espíritu a ti cuando estoy durmiendo y cuando despierto.
Why does it mention that when I'm asleep and when I'm awake?
¿Por qué menciona eso de cuando estoy durmiendo y cuando me despierto?
Judaism teaches us.
El judaísmo nos enseña
that when a person goes to bed,
que cuando una persona va a dormir,
the body and the spirit are separating.
Y el espíritu y el cuerpo se separan.
The Adon Olam prayer says in the morning.
Y luego la persona en la mañana.
In essence, when you go to bed, you are clinically dead because your body and your spirit are separating.
Cuando te vas a dormir, estás prácticamente muerto porque
when
tu cuerpo y tu espíritu están separados.
God take the body and he take the spirit.
Dios toma el cuerpo y el espíritu.
And he put them together.
Y los junta nuevamente.
He resurrect us.
Por la mañana y nos hace resucitar.
This prayer.
Esta oración,
in Judaism, is known as the prayer of resurrection.
En el judaísmo la llamamos la oración de la resurrección.
This morning, Pastor Mark Bell spoke about the Modeani.
Esta habla también del Modeani.
And here we're seeing almost a continuation. This is the prayer almost after the Modeani.
Esta es una como una continuación casi después del Modeani.
It's a prayer of resurrection.
Es una oración de resurrección.
Why this prayer is so significant for the last days?
¿Por qué esta oración es tan significativa en los últimos días?
Because we see the blueprint of God.
Porque vemos la los planos de Dios
for salvation.
Para la salvación.
God says that there are two parts to salvation.
Dios dice que hay dos partes de para la salvación.
This entire prayer is dealing with resurrection.
Esta oración completa está hablando de resurrección.
But I want you to understand that there's two aspects to it.
Pero quiero que entienda que hay dos aspectos en esto.
A personal resurrection.
Una resurrección personal.
And a corporal.
Y una resurrección corporal.
We are talking today, we've been talking all day about Israel being saved, all of Israel being saved.
Hemos estado hablando todo el día acerca de Israel que sea salvo.
How do we get there?
¿Cómo llegamos ahí?
This prayer gives us the groundwork, the blueprint, how to get there.
Esta oración nos da prácticamente los pasos de cómo llegar ahí.
You see, there are two hidden verses in this verse.
Si ven, aquí hay dos versos, dos cosas escondidas entre estos versos.
You don't see them on the screen.
No se ven en la pantalla.
I hid them intentionally.
Yo las escondí intencionalmente.
I want you to listen.
Quiero que escuchen.
To the end of the prayer.
Al final, hasta el final de la oración.
This is important. Next slide.
Es muy importante.
Here is the way the prayer is ending.
En la siguiente diapositiva vemos, aquí está.
In the Sephardic tradition.
En la tradición sefardica.
Not the Ashkenazic, in the Sephardic
tradition. No en la Ashkenazi.
And I'm sorry, the word I think is a little bit jumbled. It should go like this. I'm sorry, I see the English is messed
dice
up.
Algo así.
It's not messed up in the Siddur. It says, in his temple,
en su templo,
my soul will rejoice.
Mi alma se va a regocijar.
The Messiah,
el Mesías,
will be sent quickly.
Será enviado muy pronto.
And then I will sing.
Y luego yo veré
in his house,
en su casa,
and I will say amen, amen inside his home.
Y yo diré amén y amén dentro de su casa.
In this temple,
en este tiempo,
that's talking about the corporal salvation of the house of Israel. When Messiah come and establish the temple,
está hablando de la salvación corporal de la casa de Israel cuando el Mesías regrese al templo.
How do we get to this? This called in Hebrew Geulah Klali, the corporal salvation. How do we get to corporal salvation?
¿Y cómo llegamos a esa salvación corporal?
This prayer usually said individually, right as we get to the shul. Even some do it at their homes before they start to pray. Why?
Dicha individualmente antes de salir de tu casa.
Remember the bucket.
Recuerdan el balde.
Does Judaism believe in personal salvation?
El judaísmo cree en la salvación personal.
Oh, you better believe it.
Mejor lo creen.
To get to the corporal salvation,
para llegar a la
we need to first experience the power of the resurrection individually.
Tenemos que experimentar el poder de la resurrección individualmente.
And Judaism tried to come and tell us here that when you experience a breakthrough,
pero cuando el judaísmo nos está diciendo cuando tú experimentas,
when you overcome
este
the
yetzer hara,
the evil inclination, when you are resurrected,
cuando resucitas.
When I am asleep and when I am awake,
cuando
when I am restored back,
cuando estoy durmiendo, cuando me despierto, cuando soy restaurado,
you
de
are
regreso,
preparing the entire house of Israel for this great and awesome and glorious day.
Tú estás preparando la casa de Israel por ese maravilloso y glorioso día.
Don't think, if you belong to Israel, don't think for a second.
Si tú perteneces a Israel,
that if you have a victory over failure, it does not affect everybody. It's affect everybody, and that's what the Adol Olam prayer come to teach us.
No piensen por un segundo que todo lo que haces y que no va a tener efecto en la casa de Israel.
It's a prayer of resurrection. That's a transformation.
Es una oración de resurrección. ¿Qué transformación?
You make a difference on the corporate. You change the corporate.
Tú puedes hacer una diferencia corporal. Tú puedes cambiar a todo ese grupo.
I know it's foreign to us as Christians. I can change the salvation of Israel. Yes, you can. And yes, you will.
Pensar que puedes hacer un cambio tan grande, que eres tan importante, sí, tú puedes, sí, lo vas a hacer.
The prayer does not there and there. Look what it says here. In his sanctuary, my soul will rejoice. Right? The hidden verses.
Hay versos escondidos.
What is going to happen in the temple?
¿Qué va a suceder en el templo?
I didn't translate it correctly from Hebrew intentionally.
No lo traduje del hebreo intencionalmente.
But the word here in Hebrew,
pero la palabra en hebreo,
it says amen, amen. Dice, say with me, amen.
Dice amen, amen.
Amen.
Dígalo conmigo, amen, amen.
Shem,
Shem
Hanora.
Hanora.
Do you know what Shem Hanora means?
¿Ustedes saben lo que eso significa?
If anybody ever heard about the movement called the Sacred Name Movement?
¿Ha escuchado acerca de ese movimiento que se llama el movimiento secreto?
Shem HaNorah.
Shem HaNorah.
Literally means the literal name of God. His four letter names.
El número el nombre literal de Dios es
Guess
de
what's
cuatro
going
letras.
To happen in the temple.
Adivinen qué va a suceder en el templo.
We are standing and we are learning a song from Yeshua. Yeshua is teaching us.
Estamos aprendiendo una canción de Yeshua. Yeshua nos está enseñando. Y él nos está enseñando.
He's teaching us how to pronounce his father name.
Él nos está enseñando cómo pronunciar el nombre de
you
su padre.
You want to know why everybody with a sacred name is a liar, thief, and a snake?
¿Saben por qué un hombre escondido es un
Because they are taking the job of the Messiah. Only Yeshua knows the name of the Father, and only Yeshua will teach us the name.
Solo Yeshua conoce el nombre del Padre. Solo Yeshua nos va a dar el nombre.
Come on, are those prayers starting to be a little bit more personal now?
Está convirtiéndose en algo más personal.
It's more than that. He says that he will teach us those prayers.
Es mucho más, nos está diciendo que Él nos va a enseñar esas oraciones
When we went through our personal salvation.
Cuando vayamos a nuestra salvación personal.
But what is he talking about?
¿Pero de qué está hablando?
It's mean that each and every one of you
significa que cada uno de ustedes
speak Hebrew.
Hable hebreo.
You don't speak English.
No, inglés,
no español,
sino
no habla español.
Español.
No español. Español, no italiano, no coreano,
no
Hebrew.
Hebreo, hebreo.
We are seeing in this verse the fulfillment of Zephaniah chapter 3 verse 9.
Estamos viendo en estos versos
Zephaniah 3:9.
Zephaniah 3:9.
He said, I will flip, I will change, I will rotate
the people.
I will change what?
Cambiaré.
I will change the language.
Cambiaré la lengua.
To a language of pure lips. That's what your translation said.
Labios puros.
But the Hebrew said,
Pero en hebreo dice,
Safa Brua. Which means clear and unified language. Everybody will speak Hebrew in these days. And
if
I'm telling you right
ser,
now that
ser,
you going through personal salvation and you're meeting the Lord, you're preparing yourself to the temple, you're preparing yourself to receive Hebrew as your first language and learn God's name. Go ahead. I got to get it off my chest. I'm sorry.
Nos está diciendo de que estemos preparados que va a haber un idioma que va a bajar para nosotros y todos vamos a hablar ese mismo idioma que va a ser hebreo para todos y con eso vamos a adorar y vamos a alabar y vamos a acercarnos al Señor.
So here the prayer of Adon Olam introducing us for the same time to understand salvation through Jewish eyes.
Entonces aquí está el Adon Olam enseñándonos cómo entender
And here's
esta
what
salvación
it says next
para
slide.
El,
There are
de
two
judíos.
Different types of salvations. Two different types of salvation.
Entonces hay dos tipos de salvación.
And here is God's formula. Here is God's formula.
Y aquí está la fórmula de Dios.
Remember, the person first have to go to resurrection.
Recuerden la persona que va, que cuando se despierta va pasando una resurrección.
A personal resurrection.
Una resurrección personal.
Before Mashiach came.
Antes de que Mashiach venga.
That's called the personal resurrection, called in Hebrew Geula Pratit.
Esa es una resurrección personal que se llama Geula Pratit.
Geula Pratit. And here is the formula.
Y aquí está la fórmula.
Geula pratit,
Geula,
a personal salvation.
A personal salvación.
Of
la
one
salvación
inside
personal.
The house of Israel.
De la casa de Israel.
Will lead to the Geula of the entire house of Israel. Amen.
Va a llevar a la completa
Why do you think
salvación
Paul
de la casa
to the Gentiles?
De Israel.
Why do you think Paul said to the Gentiles? You are no longer strangers or foreigners.
Ustedes no son extranjeros ya no más.
But you are members of the household, the commonwealth of the house of all Israel. Why did he say
this? Eres miembros de la casa de Israel. ¿Por qué dijo esto?
Because when the Gentiles become part of the house of Israel,
porque cuando los gentiles sean parte de la casa de Israel,
they can head to the bucket much faster. The bucket can be filled much faster, and Israel's salvation can come much faster.
Porque ellos pueden entonces llenar esa vasija mucho más rápido, y Yeshua puede regresar mucho más rápido.
Here you go. That's why it says.
Por eso dice.
Here you go. Next slide. Go two slides. I'm going to skip a slide. Go to the next one. That's what the Adonolam pray about. This prayer is about. Next slide. Here you go. That's good. Go back. For then I will make the people pure of speech.
Para ellos daré al pueblo una lengua pura.
So that they will do what?
Para que ellos hagan qué?
They will do what? They invoke the Lord by name.
Para que ellos qué? Para que
ellos invoquen al Señor. How will they invoke him by name?
Para que ellos invoquen al Señor por nombre.
Do you understand what power there is in the name of God?
¿Entienden ustedes el poder que
they
hay en el nombre de Dios?
They will invoke him by name because Yeshua is going to teach us the name.
Llamarlos por su nombre porque Yeshua nos va a enseñar el nombre.
Your salvation means that all of Israel is getting ready to learn the name of God and invoke his name.
Tu salvación va a ser que todo Israel conozca el nombre de Dios y todo Israel.
And serve him with one accord.
Y lo sirvan en una
you understand what we're doing here? When we sing Adonolam Hashem Malach, we are ready to invoke God in one name, one heart, and one accord. We are rehearsing for this day.
Estamos ensayando para servir a Dios.
Aleluya.
Estamos ensayando para servir a Dios, para recibirlo en un solo cuerdo.
Can we go to another one? Are we ready to decode the next one?
Okay, decodicemos la.
I want you to hear this prayer. Go to the next slide first. I want you to read this as we hear this in Hebrew. A prayer, one of the most important Jewish prayer that read every day, including on the Shabbat. Kol Nishmat Kol Chai.
Esta es una oración que se hace inclusive en el Shabbat y todos los días.
A soul of every living being.
Se llama Nishmata Kol Chai.
Here we go. Let's hear it.
Para todo ser viviente.
Nishmat Kol Chai, Tivarech et Shimcha Adonai Eloheinu, Beruach Kol Basar, Tivaer Promem Zichrecha Malkeinu Tamid. Kamor L'David, Barechi Nafshi et Adonai, V'chol keravai et shem kodesho.
Amazing. Did you sense the anointing in this prayer?
¿Sienten esa unción?
This is an important prayer.
Esta es una oración muy importante.
That says, let's say together prophetically, the soul of every living thing will bless your name, Adonai our God, and the spirit of all flesh will glorify and exalt your memory eternally. Our King, from eternity and to eternity, you are God, and other than you, we have no king, redeemer, or Savior, liberator, rescuer, sustainer, and compassionate one. In any time of distress and woe, we have no king but you. God of the beginning and the end, God of all creation, masters of all generation, who is extolled in abundance of praises, who guide his world in kindness and his creation with compassion. Adonai does not slumber or sleep. He who rouses and sleep and weakens slumberance, who gives speech to the speechless and who releases the captive and who support the falling, strengthens, let's me, the, I don't have the end of it. Okay, you have it. Now, when you look at this prayer in Hebrew, you're going to notice that it's have five verses.
Si miran esta oración en hebreo, tiene cinco versos.
Who is the author of this important prayer?
¿Quién es el autor de esta oración tan importante?
Let's play a game together and look at the beginning of each verse.
Miremos el principio de cada verso.
Next slide. Shochen Ad. What is the first letter called?
Shochen. ¿Cuál es la primera letra? Shin.
Let's go to the next verse. Mi Idme.
El segundo verso empieza con la letra Mem.
Ad Hine Ezrunu. Ezrenu. Ezrunu. Next slide. Next, I mean. Yeah. Ad Hine Ezrunu. What's the next letter?
¿Cuál es la primera letra de la siguiente?
Ve'ile Pinenu Vav.
Ve'ile Vav.
And now, last but not least, Nishmat Kol Chai.
Y la siguiente, la última, es
the author of the prayer,
el autor de las oraciones,
have left us his name signature,
nos ha dejado su nombre como
in the prayer,
firma en la oración.
Anybody know what name this is spelling out?
Ustedes saben, ¿quién sabe cómo qué nombre está deletreando estas letras?
What name does it spell? Shimon. 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 Shimon who?
Shimon who? Quién?
Are you kidding me? Are you joking with me?
¿Están bromeando?
Jewish tradition.
La tradición judía.
I'm quoting straight from here. Teaches us.
Nos enseña.
That this prayer,
que estas oraciones,
was written by Simon
fue
Peter.
Escrito por Simón Pedro.
Shimon Kepha.
Shimon Kepha.
The very first, the very same one that they called the first pope.
El mismo que han nombrado, le han dado nombre al Papa.
And I quote from Jewish sources here in the Siddur.
Y esto es de información judía del Siddur.
This is not messianic. This is Orthodox Judaism.
Esto es de los judíos ortodoxos.
And he,
y él,
Simon Peter,
Simón Pedro,
served the God of the fathers.
Sirvió al Dios de los padres.
Are you shocked? And he wrote many songs.
Y él escribió muchas canciones.
And he sent them to every border.
Y dijo cada,
of the borders of the house of Israel,
a todos a los de la casa
so
de Israel,
that they will be remembered in every generation.
Para que ellos sean recordados en cada generación.
And in the Jewish literature, it does not known as Simon Peter.
Y en la cultura judía no se sabe que es Simón Pedro.
He have another name.
Tenía otro nombre.
Rabbi Simon Peter.
Rabino Simón Pedro.
Could it be? Go back to this prayer for a moment.
Podría ser, y vuelvan a estas oraciones.
That every Jew in the world,
que cada judío en el mundo,
who say the soul of every living thing will bless your name, and it's praying about Yeshua.
Que cada judío que está orando, que cada alma de cada persona está orando a Yeshua.
You don't believe me because I'm telling you it's under our notes. It is here in the pages. Yeshua is here.
No, me pueden creer que Yeshua está a través de esta oración, estas oraciones en el libro.
I am sure that I'm going to be crucified by the anti-missionaries Here is my challenge to the anti-missionaries.
Este es mi reto a los misioneros.
Does it say it in Jewish literature? Yes or no? That's all what I want to know.
Dice eso en la literatura judía, ¿sí o no? Eso es lo que
quiero saber. Of course others say, come and say, no, no, claro, it cannot be Simon.
No,
it cannot be Simon.
Eso no puede ser Simon. No puede ser Simón. No, Simón.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, sí.
Wait until Hanukkah.
Esperen hasta Hanukkah.
My new book, Rabbi Simon Peter, is coming out.
Mi nuevo libro va a ser el Rabino Simón Pedro.
Simon Peter did not just wrote Nishmat Kol Chai. Wait. What we're going to deliver to the world? Simon Peter wrote many of the most revered and loved Jewish poetry.
Simón Pedro escribió muchos de las poesías que son bellísimas.
Including the prayer, many of the prayers for the Day of Atonement.
Inclusive la oración para el Día del
Atonement. You look at me in disbelief.
Ustedes no lo creerían.
But I'm telling you, it's the truth. It's the truth.
Pero yo les digo, es la verdad, es la pura verdad.
Yeshua is in here.
Yeshua está aquí.
And we said there is no other king but you.
Y decimos, no hay otro rey
más que tú. I believe that he's talking about Yeshua.
Está hablando de Yeshua.
Our Messiah.
El Mesías.
Are you excited?
¿Están emocionados?
Who's going to start to pray Nishmat Kol Chai? Who's going to start to pray this prayer regularly?
¿Qué quiere decir esta oración regularmente, todos los días?
Yes. Is that a man? Can I hear a man? Can
sí,
I hear a man?
Amen.
Oh my gosh, I have so much to tell you. But if I tell you everything, you won't buy the book. I want you to buy the book because I want you to pray.
¿Por qué quiero que compres el libro? Es para que porque quiero que ores.
Aleluya. Can we move to the next one? Can we move to another one? Are you ready for one more?
¿Están listos para una más?
How many of you heard about the prayer that called the Amidah prayer?
¿Quiénes conocen la oración que se llama Amidah?
The Amidah prayer?
La oración de Amidah?
The very first section.
La primera sección.
Is called the Avot.
Se llama the Avot.
The Avot being the, Avot. The fathers, okay?
Que significa los padres.
I want you to listen to it as to this prayer together.
Quiero que escuchen esta oración.
Let's listen to this important Jewish prayer.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Elohei Avoteinu Elohei Abraham Elohei Yitzchak Elohei Yaakov Ha'el ha'gadol ha'gibor ha'nora El Elyon Gomel chasadim tovim V'konei ha'kol V'zocher chastei avot U'mevi ge'ula Livnei v'neihem L'ma'an shemo be'ahava Melech ozer u'moshia u'magen Baruch atah Adonai Magen Avraham.
Isn't it beautiful? Let's say it together. Blessed are you. Whoa, 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 whoa. What are you doing sitting, praying, eating the standing prayer?
Esta es una oración
de... Hello, you're in training.
Yeah.
Here we go, that's better. Blessed are you, Adonai our God, and God of our Father, God of Abraham, God of Isaac and God of Jacob, the great God, mighty and awesome, God Most High, who bestows good kindness and purchases all, who remembers the kindness of the patriarchs and bring a redeemer to their children's children for his sake, name in love, King, Helper, Savior, and Shield. Blessed are you, Adonai, Shield of Abraham. Amen. You may be seated. This is such an important prayer that is actually prayed 3 times a day.
Esta es una oración muy importante que se recita 3 veces al día.
The question, first of all, that I want to challenge us with.
La primera pregunta que quiero hacerles un reto.
We know that this prayer was already prayer in Yeshua's time. We know that.
Sabemos que esto fue también orado por Yeshua.
How do I know?
Como yo sé.
100 times.
100 veces.
I mean 100%.
100%.
Too excited. That Yeshua prayed the Amidah.
Que Yeshua oraba la Amidah.
What if I tell you?
¿Qué si yo les digo?
That Yeshua refer to the Amidah prayer.
Que Yeshua se refería a la Amidah.
Clearly.
Muy
and if
claramente.
Yeshua spoke about this,
y Yeshua habló acerca de
you
esto,
know that it's important. Amen.
Y ustedes saben que si él lo hizo, es
look
importante,
with
¿verdad?
Me in Mark 11:25.
Miren conmigo en Marcos 11:25.
And when you stand praying, look at this.
Y cuando
come on,
de pie orando.
If you have anything against someone, I forgive him, so that your Father in heaven may forgive your offenses.
No, and cuando estés orando de pie, tú estarás.
Yeshua, pray the Amidah.
No lo harás en contra de nadie.
And that
para
is
que
what
el
he
Señor
said when you,
perdone tus ofensas.
When he said when you stand praying, he knew that people would pray the Amidah 3 times a day in the temple. They would go up and they would pray the Amidah.
Entonces, cuando se ponía era, él sabía que la gente en el templo oraba 3 veces al día en la Amidah.
What is this prayer about? Okay, Yeshua prayed it.
Si Yeshua lo oraba.
So, number one, if Yeshua prayed it, you better pray it.
Entonces, si Yeshua lo oraba, tú mejor lo oras.
By the way, I got to tell you something great.
Quiero decirles algo muy grande.
I put all the transliteration for you.
Puse toda la transliteración.
So you can pretend to know Hebrew.
Para que ustedes pretendan que
until
sepan
Yeshua
Hebrew.
Will fix you all up in the temple. You have a training wheel. Hallelujah.
Estas son sus llantitas de entrenamiento.
There is something though deeper about this prayer. I want you to look deeper with me for a moment.
Hay algo muy especial en estas oraciones.
Go
quiero
back
que miren
to the
una
prayer.
Forma más profunda.
Go back to the prayer. Put back the prayer.
Regresen a la, hay que regresar a la oración.
Where's all the Hebrew scholars? Not my students, except to my students. What is the very first word in the prayer?
¿Cuál es la primera palabra que se lee?
Baruch. How is the
Baruch.
End the prayer ending? What is the end of the prayer?
¿Cómo termina esta oración? ¿Cuál es el final de la oración?
Yes, but look at the last verse.
Pero miren el último verso.
You notice something odd about this prayer?
¿Saben ustedes acerca de esta oración?
It's the only prayer in the Siddur.
Es la única oración en el Siddur.
As we started this important section called the standing section.
Cuando empezamos esta sección importante que se llama la sección de pie.
That starts with the word Baruch.
Que empieza con la palabra Baruch,
and with the word Baruch.
Y termina con la palabra Baruch.
And sometimes you will see the Jews do that when they pray. They say Baruch. They bow down.
Entonces a veces ustedes van a ver los judíos que dicen Baruch.
Why are they doing this? What's
¿por qué hacen
wrong with
eso?
Them? Something is in their tuches. Why? Why are they doing this?
¿Qué anda mal en ellos?
They just like to shake it. There's something much deeper here.
Algo más profundo.
Let's look for a second, go to the next slide. Now that we know that Yeshua prayed this prayer, Yeshua came and he's given us, first of all, a chidush, a renewal of the prayer. He said, don't enter to the Amidah.
Ahora que sabemos Yeshua oraba estas oraciones.
That's a big one because like during the Amidah prayer is the center prayer in the Shabbat, in Shabbat morning or in the weekdays. The Amidah is like the meat. It's the main event.
Okay, la Amidah es una la oración más importante, es como una carne, es el evento más importante.
Pray the prayer if you have somebody against something.
Pero Yeshua dijo que no ores esa oración si tienes algo en contra de alguien.
Remember that I explained to you earlier what is a takana, passing a regulation on a prayer.
¿Recuerdan eso que les decía, pasando una regulación en una oración?
Yeshua does what every Jewish rabbi in the world does. He is passing a takana on Jewish law already. He is putting something on top of Jewish law.
Eso es lo que Yeshua está haciendo, está pasando sobre otros. Eso es como una ley sobre una ley.
But why Yeshua said that?
¿Pero por qué dice Yeshua esto?
You need to ask yourself the question. You see, you read this verse and you said, well, you just don't want us to pray if we feel something against somebody. Right?
Entonces está diciendo qué, o sea que tú no quieres que yo ore si tengo algo en contra de alguien.
I have something against you.
Tengo algo en contra de ti.
I should not pray this prayer.
No debería yo orar esta oración.
You don't understand, Yeshua validate the importance of the prayer. Everybody sees that.
Ustedes están notando la importancia de esta oración, todos lo pueden ver.
But why?
¿Pero por qué?
Why Yeshua said this?
¿Por qué Yeshua dijo esto?
You need to understand what this prayer is about.
Tienen que entender.
Next slide. This prayer I call decoding the prayer together, a roadmap to the redemption.
A esto yo le llamo decodizando la oración juntos, un mapa para el camino hacia
the redemption.
La redención.
The word Baruch have four meanings.
La palabra Baruch tiene cuatro significados.
It means to bow down.
Significa arrodillarse.
It means to kneel.
Agacharse.
It means a knee. It means like a knee.
Poner las rodillas bajo.
But here is the definition that I want you to focus on today.
Pero esta es la definición en la que yo quiero que ustedes se enfoquen hoy día.
The word Baruch.
La palabra Baruch
is an agricultural term.
Es una palabra agricultura.
It's been to be grafted in.
Que significa ser injertado.
Every Jew in the world.
Y cada judío en el mundo.
Ask three times a day. To be grafted in. That's a dirty little secret that I need to tell you. Every Jew in the world asking when you say Baruch Atah. We are asking to be grafted in.
Están pidiendo cuando hacen ese agacharse, están pidiendo ser injertados.
The process. We learned something just from the beginning of the prayer that is significant.
Estamos aprendiendo algo del significado del principio de esta oración.
You know, the Gentiles said, we are grafted into Israel. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Decimos, vamos a estar con Israel. Yeah, sí, sí, sí. What?
The engraftment is a Jewish concept.
Ser injertado es un concepto judío.
And it's something that you have to go at every day.
Y es algo que tú tienes que hacer cada día.
You cannot say I'm grafted to Israel today, but tomorrow I'm not, and tomorrow the next day I am. You have to thrive every day.
Y es algo que tienes que hacer día a día. No puedes decir hoy día estoy injertado y mañana no y después decir al siguiente día también.
Now you understand why.
Tiene que ser día a día.
Now you understand why Yeshua said that you have to first make sure that you forgive.
Ahora puedes entender por qué Yeshua dijo. Tú mejor debes de perdonar.
Because Yeshua understands the corporal salvation of the house of Israel.
Porque Yeshua entiende la salvación corporal de la casa de Israel.
If a person is engrafted,
si una persona es injertada,
but his little branch has poison,
pero su corazón está con veneno,
who it's affecting?
¿Quién es afectado?
The entire tree.
Todo el árbol.
It's infecting the entire community.
Infecta toda la comunidad.
So Yeshua is telling us here, when we are looking to be engrafted, we must make sure that we are clean before God before asking to join the house of Israel. This is a revolutionary process.
Entonces, cuando Yeshua dice tienes que estar limpio para ser injertado, es un proceso revolucionario.
Yeshua here is giving us an interpretation that has never been heard before.
Yeshua nos está dando una interpretación que nunca se ha visto antes.
Why do we want to be engrafted in?
¿Por qué queremos ser injertados?
Let's read. Go back to the prayer, please, JJ.
Regresamos a la oración.
Go back to the prayer. If you read the prayer quickly, I give you 15 seconds. Read the prayer in English.
Lea la oración otra vez en inglés.
If you were to choose one word in the English language,
si puedes escoger una palabra en el idioma inglés,
that speak about the theme of this prayer, what would you say?
Que habla acerca del tema básico de esta oración,
¿cuál
sería?
What is the one word that is jumped at you? Remember? Try again. What is the... Who said that? You just passed Liturgy 101 with Rabbi Shapira.
Israel el Redentor.
He's not even my student.
No es ni siquiera mi estudiante, ya pasó.
My own student failed, and this guy, whoever he is, he get a medal.
Sea quien sea.
He must be Jewish.
A lo mejor otro judío.
He says that the central theme is these words.
Que el hijo de la redención.
And bring a redeemer to the children, The key word here is the word redeemer.
Y trae un redentor a los hijos de los hijos. El rey trae un redentor.
This prayer has to do with redemption.
Esta oración tiene que ver con redención.
And God is giving us in one Jewish prayer the entire roadmap.
Y Dios nos está dando en una sola oración la base de toda la redención.
Redemption starts with engrafting.
La redención,
write yourself this in your own. Redemption starts with engrafting.
La redención empieza con ser injertados. Grábense esto. La redención empieza con ser injertados.
Engrafting is a process.
Y el ser injertados es un proceso.
So that's the roadmap. Let's read it carefully.
No, sé que este es el camino, el mapa.
Blessed are you, Adonai our God, and God of our fathers.
Señor Dios nuestro,
God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob.
Dios Abraham, Dios Isaac y Jacob.
The great, mighty, and awesome,
el gran,
most
poderoso,
high, who bestowed kindness and purchases everything.
Dios de bondad y lo obtiene todo.
And he remembered the kindness of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Y recuerda la amabilidad, la bondad de los patriarcas.
And he bring a redeemer.
Y trae a nuestro redentor.
Let me ask you a question.
Déjenme que les pregunte.
How does he bring a redeemer to the world?
¿Cómo trae el redentor al mundo?
How? Just randomly.
¿Cómo?
Notice that in the verse before,
noten que en el verso anterior,
it's mentioned purchases everything.
Él menciona que compra todo.
Where do we see in the Bible?
¿Dónde vemos en la Biblia?
This concept of purchasing.
Este concepto de comprar.
Everything. Not my student, close your mouths.
Por favor, mis estudiantes, no digan nada.
Where do we see in the Bible?
¿Dónde vemos esto?
It's in the Bible.
Es en la Biblia.
I'm going to give you a hint.
Les voy a dar una pista.
According to Rav Shaul, Apostle Paul's salvation starts with whom?
De acuerdo al rabino Shaul, salvación empieza con quién?
Start with whom?
¿Con quién?
Hey, who said it again? Oh my gosh, come to the yeshiva, I love you. We have superstars in El Shaddai. Paul made the point again and again and again that salvation does not start with Yeshua, but through the Abrahamic covenant.
Paul lo dice una y otra vez que la salvación va a venir de los judíos.
Remember, Yeshua prayed this prayer. He knew this prayer. We already see this.
Recuerden, Yeshua conocía esta oración. Él oraba esta oración.
And the prayer says that he bring a redeemer who, before he bring a redeemer, he's going to purchase everything.
Y la oración dice que va a traer un redentor que va a comprarlo todo.
So where is the origin of this prayer?
Va a pagar por todo.
Look with me in the text. Next slide, please.
Miremos el siguiente texto.
The Torah tells us. Next slide. Here we go. Next slide. Here you go. What are you doing? Next slide. There you go. And King Melchizedek of Salem brought out bread and wine And he was the priest of God, Most High, Malchizedek.
Y decía que era el príncipe del lo más alto, el Melquisedec.
And he blessed Abraham. He said, "What?"
Y bendijo a Abraham.
Blessed are you, Abraham.
Y le dijo, bendito eres Abraham.
Blessed be Abraham of God, Most High.
De Dios, el más altísimo.
Creators of heaven and earth. Is
that creador what it says? Del cielo y la tierra.
No. Your Bible is wrong. It says in Hebrew,
Kone,
say with me, Kone Shamayim Va'aretz. Purchaser of all things. Exactly the word of the prayer, beloved.
Pero acá dice en realidad en el hebreo no dice lo mismo, dice otra cosa. Dice
in the
compra,
prayer, when we
paga
say,
por todo, como
in
dice
the prayer,
la oración
when we say,
de
call a purchaser of all things, please understand he's talking about Abraham.
Por favor, entiendo, está hablando de Abraham.
And he's talking about what Abraham did.
Y está hablando acerca de lo que Abraham dijo.
Let me ask you a question. Why Melchizedek bless Abraham? What did Abraham did?
¿Por qué Melchizedek bendijo a Abraham? ¿Qué es lo que hizo?
What did Abraham did?
¿Qué hizo Abraham?
Who did he purchase?
¿A quién compró?
He purchased Lot.
Él compró a Lot.
He redeemed his brother.
Él redimió a su hermano.
Remember, he redeemed him physically and spiritually.
Recuerden, lo redimió físicamente y espiritualmente.
The prayer gives us the blueprint for the redemption.
La oración nos da este plano de la redención.
If one wants to bring a redemption to the world,
si alguien quiere traer redención al mundo,
if you want to see the Messiah coming,
si quieren ver al Mesías que venga,
he must focus on the relationship on the horizontal level rather than the vertical level. That's what it means to be engrafted to the house of Israel.
Tiene que enfocarse en una relación horizontal en lugar de vertical. Eso es lo que significa ser injertado a la casa de Israel.
If one want to see Yeshua glorious return,
todos queremos ver a Yeshua, el regreso de Yeshua, el glorioso regreso.
You need to go and purchase some souls.
Tienes que ir a comprar almas.
We call it evangelism.
Le llamamos evangelización.
How evangelistic is the Amidah prayer?
¿Qué evangelista es esta oración de cuán evangelista es esta oración de Amidah?
You want to see God come down from heaven?
Si quieres ver a Dios que venga del cielo,
bring people closer to you.
Trae gente cerca a él.
The Torah should bring people closer to you, not away from you, for crying out loud.
La Torah tiene que hacer que tú atraigas gente hacia ti. No, al contrario.
Why are all of those Gentiles Torah observant messianic?
¿Por qué todos esos Torah observadores mesiánicos?
They always have problems with their families.
Se separan de sus familias.
They always hate everybody around them.
Hay odio con toda la gente alrededor de ellos.
And they're so angry.
Están tan molestos.
Instead of bringing the Geulah, they are delayed.
En lugar de ellos traer el kehulah, ellos están haciendo más tarde.
That's why Yeshua said, first forgive and then be engrafted.
Por eso Yeshua les dice, primero perdone, luego serás
injertado. I'm telling you, those prayers better be ministering to you today, because that's what it's meant to be messianic.
Porque eso es lo que significa ser mesiánico.
The avot prayer is explained like this by Yeshua.
Siguiente oración es explicada por Yeshua.
Yohanan 15, he says this next slide.
Yohanan 16 dice esto.
No one has greater love than a person who lays down his life for his friends.
Nadie tiene un amor más grande que aquel que da su vida por sus amigos.
You understand that this term that is used here by Yeshua, the one who laid down his life.
Ustedes entienden que este verso que fue usado por Yeshua porque dio su vida.
Is the greatest virtue by Jewish law.
es el, el es la virtud más grande de acuerdo a la ley judía.
Jewish law does not allow human sacrifice. Everybody need to understand it. Human sacrifice is illegal. The Torah tells us.
La ley judía prohíbe completamente sacrificio humano. Ustedes tienen que entender, está totalmente en contra de la Torah.
Yeshua speak about something called mesirut.
Mesías habla del Yeshua.
One who freely give his life for his brother.
Cuando alguien voluntariamente da su vida por su hermano.
When Abraham went, he risked his life. He risked his life for Lot.
Cuando Abraham arriesgó su vida por nosotros.
When you take a risk for your brother,
perdón por Lot, él arriesgó su vida por Lot. Cuando
you are
tú arriesgas tu vida
the coming
por tu hermano,
of the Messiah.
Estás acelerando el regreso del Mesías.
That's why we pray this prayer three times a day. God, give me a chance to risk my life toward my brother.
Entonces, por eso oramos, hacemos esta oración tres veces al día. Dios, dame la oportunidad de arriesgar mi vida por mi
hermano.
Creo que ya te estás sintiendo un poco incómodo acerca de este
I'm
libro pequeño.
The more you understand, the more your life will be changed.
Pero yo les digo que mientras más lo entiendan, más su vida va a cambiar.
This prayer, the Amidah, is so important, and that's what Yeshua speaking about.
Esta oración de Amidah, que es histórica, de la que Yeshua está hablando.
Because it gives us Judaism golden rule.
Porque es judaísmo.
One, the golden rule of the entire Torah.
Es la regla de oro de la Torah por completo.
One willing to lay his life down.
Alguien que da su vida.
Can bring atonement.
Puede traer expiación.
And can bring the geula.
Y traer la geula.
And that's why I say, come in cleanly in. Before you start this journey, you cannot redeem somebody if you have something against somebody else.
Por eso tienes que venir limpio. No puedes entrar a esto cuando tienes algo en contra de alguien.
Sometimes we have the feeling of the thought, oh, I like Sherry. You know, I really like Sherry.
Por ejemplo, podemos decir, por ejemplo, a mí me cae muy bien Sherry. Me
so
gusta Sherry.
So I'm going to do everything in my power to be a blessing to Sherry.
Entonces, ¿qué puedo hacer para hacer una bendición para Sherry?
But this guy, Pastor Belts.
Pero este hombre, Pastor Belts.
I don't like him.
No me cae bien.
So I'm going to exclude him on the corner.
It's
okay, because I'm doing a good mitzvah toward the one person. You see what this is? The Torah speak against exclusions.
Oh, la Torah explica en contra de las de
Israel is inclusivity.
Israel tiene que ser inclusivo.
The synagogue need to be a place of inclusivity.
La sinagoga tiene que ser algo de inclusión.
And then you can enter in and lay your life, and that's how the redemption comes to the world.
Puedes entrar y poner tu vida y ahí es cuando la redención va a venir.
The rabbis even took it a step further and look at what they say to explain to us, to extrapolate on what Yeshua is telling us.
Los rabinos van un paso más allá para explicar lo que Yeshua está diciendo.
How many of you heard that Yeshua cannot be the Messiah because a human being cannot die for the sins of others? How many of you heard this idiotic argument before?
¿Cuántos han escuchado que Yeshua no puede ser el Mesías porque no se supone que otro ser humano no debe morir?
It is true. Yeshua cannot be sacrificed.
Es verdad, Yeshua no podía ser sacrificado.
But Yeshua can choose to give his life.
Pero él escogió dar su vida.
They are not the same.
No es lo mismo.
And that's what Yeshua referring to here through the page of Judaism.
Por eso a eso es a lo que Yeshua se refiere.
That's what brings the redemption again.
Esa es la redención.
One willingly give his life.
Cuando alguien da su vida.
Here's the golden rule. Next slide.
Acá hay una regla de oro.
And if you want the reference, that's found in Moed Katan, Tractate 28a. Moed Katan 28a. Here's what it says. Rabbi Ami said.
Rabbi Ami dijo.
Why was the Torah portion that described the third of of Miriam
la to expose
to the portion dealing with the red heifer?
¿Por qué la porción de la Torah que describe la muerte de Miriam se relaciona con la del
red heifer?
Becerro rojo.
To the red heifer. To tell you, just as the red heifer atones for sins, so is the date of the righteous.
Para decir que
for sin.
Así como la vaca roja hace expiación por los pecados, también así.
Rabbi Elazar says, let me just read it in English, it might be too difficult. Why was the Torah portion that described the death of Aaron as opposed to the portion discussing the priestly garment? This statement that the just as the priestly garment atones for sin, so is the death of the righteous that it atones for sin.
La muerte de un justo hace expiación por el pecado. El Rabí Eleazar dijo, ¿por qué la porción de Torah describe la muerte de Aarón y habla acerca de los vestimentos del sacerdote? Esto nos enseña que en estos vestimentos hay expiación por el pecado también.
This is significant. This is important. I want you to understand this.
Esto es importante y quiero que entiendan esto.
He says he's a purchaser. The person is a purchaser of all things.
Dice que es la compra de todas
and
las cosas.
And I want to ask you a question. Who want to purchase your own brother today in the house?
¿En quién quiero hacerles una pregunta? ¿Quién quiere pagar por su hermano hoy en día en toda la casa?
You want to purchase your brother?
¿Tú quieres pagar por tu hermano?
Those who want to purchase your brother, stand up for a second. There you go. There you go. If you don't want to do it, it's fine. Just don't be in the house of Israel. That's cool. Remain in Goyishville. I don't care. There you go. Everybody's standing. Why did I have to say that? You need to jump up. Here's what you have to do.
Esto es lo que tienes que hacer.
According to Yeshua. This is the renewal of Yeshua. He's giving a sermon on the prayer.
De acuerdo a Yeshua.
Look at the crowd right now and ask yourself a question.
Miren este grupo, quiero hacerles una pregunta.
Am I willing to die, to give my life freely?
Estoy dispuesto a dar mi vida voluntariamente.
To the person next to me.
A la persona que está a mi lado.
That is what the Avot prayer is about.
Eso es lo que el diablo detesta más.
Only this type of love.
Solo este tipo de amor.
Will bring
traerá
the Messiah,
el Mesías
of Israel.
De Israel.
This type of love,
este tipo de amor,
called Mesirut Nefesh,
llamado sin,
but it's also called, according to this prayer,
llamado también a la oración,
Gomel Chasadim.
Gomel Chasadim.
Chesed is grace,
Chesed is gracia,
but that's not what it is in Hebrew.
Pero no es lo que dice en hebreo.
It's meant to do an undeserved act of loving kindness.
Esto es un acto de amor y bondad que uno no merece.
Listen to what the men of the great assembly said. Next slide. Just listen.
Esto es lo que los grandes hombres dicen.
Simon the righteous was among the last surviving members of the great assembly.
Simon?
He would say, the world stands
Simon dice,
on three things: Torah, the service of God, and deeds of loving kindness. If you want to pray the Amidah prayer, if you want to say the Avot, please know what you are entering into. You are entering into a covenant with every Jew in the world and any member of the house of Israel. And you are saying this, I am willing to die for you. Now my question is, who is willing to die? Who is willing to die for a Jew to come in? Thanks God that I see one hand in the crowd. Two hands. Not so far on being messianic now, huh? You will be challenged, but that's what Yeshua is speaking about. saying. So when you pray down, me down, do exactly what Yeshua is telling you to do. Making sure that you know what you do. You're saying, God, I'm willing to go and risk my life for the body, for the house, because in that a redemption is going to come. God is looking right now for people who are going to be risk takers. And I pray that you will be risk takers. In these last days, He's looking for risk takers. Thank you. You may be seated. And no need to. It's too long. Wow. Can I go last one?
Or maybe
it's too much. You have strength for one more? Are you sure?
¿Tienen fuerza para la última, una más?
Here we go.
Here we go.
We're going to play the next one. Put it on the screen. It's one of the most important and most dramatic
una,
Jewish prayers.
La última, una de las más importantes, las más dramáticas de las oraciones judías.
It's called the Kaddish.
Se llama Kaddish.
We cry this prayer upon all of Israel every day.
Que todo Israel ora cada día.
As a prayer of exaltation.
Como oración por la nación.
Listen to this prayer together.
Yitgadal v'yitkadash shemei rabbah.
Congregation.
Amen. Continue. Be'alma divarach irutei v'yamlich malchutei. Bechayechon uv'yomechon uv'chayed chol beit Yisrael.
Congregation joins you.
Ba'agala, ba'agala, uvizman kariv imru.
Congregation,
amen, together. Yehesh me rabbah mevarach le'alam lame amaya yitbarach.
Continue.
Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitroman v'yitnasei v'yitadar v'yitale v'yitalal shmei degurishah.
Congregation.
Berichu.
Continue.
Le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata.
Congregation joins you.
Tush bechata v'nechemata da'amiran b'alma v'imru.
Everyone,
amen.
And then usually you end, oh, Seh shalom b'imromav u'yaseh shalom aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. Now what if I would tell you that Yeshua knew this prayer, sang this prayer? He probably have his own melody.
¿Qué si les digo que Yeshua cantó esta oración, hizo esta oración y quizás tuvo su propia melodía?
The oldest form of this prayer.
La forma de esta oración
is found in the New Testament.
La más antigua se encuentra en el Nuevo Testamento.
Let's read this together. Let's say it together.
Digámoslo
May juntos. His great name grow exalted and sanctified in the world which he made to his will. May his kingdom, join me, reign. May his redemption sprout. And may he hasten the coming of Yeshua, his Messiah, in lifetime of our days and in the lifetime of the entire house of Israel, swiftly and soon, and let us say amen. Let's pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, may your name be sanctified.
Este es el Padre
may your
nuestro.
Kingdom come, as in your will be done in heavens. May it also be done in earth. Give us the bread that is our allotment today, and forgive us our debts indebted to us, and do not. Amen. Did Yeshua knew this prayer?
¿Yeshua sabía esta oración?
Let's look for a second real quick at Matthew chapter 6. You will never think about the Lord's Prayer the same way.
Miremos en Mateo capítulo 6, nunca va a ver esta oración de la misma forma.
Yeshua said, next slide, he said, when you pray, Matthew 6,
Yeshua dijo,
don't babble. Yeshua didn't want us to babble some weird languages.
Dijo, cuando ores, no balbucees.
Why?
No quiso que,
because prayer is to be understood by the community.
Porque la oración, ¿por qué? Porque la oración tiene que ser hecha
en
comunidad.
It is to edify the community.
Es para ayudar a la comunidad.
Don't babble like the pagans.
No balbucees como el pagano.
Who think God will heal them better if they roll on the floor, or they bark like dogs.
Y si empiezan a ladrar como perros.
Just learn how to pray in Hebrew. Believe me, it's good enough for God. Don't be like them, because your Father knows what you need before you ask Him. You therefore pray like that.
No seas como ellos, porque tu Padre que sabe qué necesitas antes de preguntar. Por lo tanto, reza así.
Hitkadash shimcha, tavo malchutcha, ya'aseh retzoncha, ka'asher b'shamayim gam ba'aretz. You know, I shared this story recently.
Yo conté esa historia últimamente.
There was an Orthodox newspaper who printed the Lord's Prayer.
Había un periódico ortodoxo que publicó la oración del Señor,
and the author, the readers who are Orthodox discovered that it is actually written from Yeshua's word.
Y muchos de ellos dijeron de que fue escrito de las palabras de Yeshua.
It's caused a big uproar in Israel. What do you mean? You printing the word of this bastard?
Entonces todo hubo un escándalo en Israel. ¿Cómo es que están orando esta oración y le dieron una palabra fea a Yeshua?
The author of the article wrote, which word in the Lord's Prayer you disagree with? Which word in the Lord's Prayer going against our core faith as Jews?
Entonces le dijeron, ¿qué palabra, cuál palabra en toda esta oración de Yeshua va en contra de las leyes de los judíos?
You know what? Not a single person could speak against the Lord.
Y saben que ni siquiera una persona pudo hablar en contra.
Look with me carefully. Let's learn a little bit Hebrew quickly. Next slide. The resemblance between Yeshua's words to the Kaddish is incredible.
Las palabras de Yeshua son muy se reflejan, son muy parecidas a la del Kaddish.
The Lord's Prayer mentioned in two places, Matthew chapter 6 and Luke chapter 11.
En Lucas 11.
And Luke chapter 11.
Lucas 11.
And both of them start with the word Hitkadash Shimcha.
En ambos empieza con Kadash Simcha.
What is the word in the white? You have the words both in Hebrew and the word in Aramaic.
¿Cuáles son las palabras aquí en el hebreo y en el arameo?
Every Jewish toddler, if you put him next to Yeshua words,
a cada niño judío si lo pones al lado de las palabras de Yeshua,
and the word of the Kaddish,
y las palabras del Kaddish,
it will tell you they are exact same word, the exact same prayer, just abbreviated.
Te va a decir exactamente las mismas palabras, solo abreviadas.
Yeshua stood up and probably said, Hitkadash Shimcha. That's what Yeshua would
Yeshua
say.
Esto es lo que Yeshua decía.
And the Jewish prayer would say, Hitkadal veHitkadash. The exact same prayer.
Y la oración del judío decía esto. Es exactamente la misma oración.
And what is the next word that Yeshua said?
¿Y cuál es la siguiente oración?
May your name be sanctified.
Que tu nombre sea santificado.
Let your kingdom come.
Y que tu reino venga.
What is the word of the Kaddish? What is the third line in the Kaddish?
¿Cuál es la palabra en el Kaddish?
וימליך מלכותו, and let his kingdom be created and established.
Que su reino sea creado y establecido.
The entire Kaddish is a prayer about the kingdom established.
La oración entera del Kaddish es acerca del reinado y que sea establecido.
And here is the amazing thing.
Y acá vino lo más asombroso.
There is no Jewish resource until the third century.
No hay resources del judío hasta el
third century.
Del tercer siglo.
That report the full Kaddish prayer.
Que haya traído el Kaddish, la oración del
Kaddish. Do you know what is the oldest form of the Kaddish prayer?
¿Ustedes saben lo que es esto?
The Lord's Prayer.
La oración del Señor.
The Lord's Prayer is the oldest Jewish form of a prayer that we know of.
La oración del Señor es la base del Kaddish.
To you, it's maybe not sound amazing, but for me as a Jew, it is amazing to see Yeshua.
No sé si para ustedes es asombroso, pero para mí es muy asombroso que es Yeshua.
The New Testament is. Christian book.
El Nuevo Testamento, este libro cristiano.
The very first version of the Kaddish prayer.
Habla del primer verso de la oración Kaddish.
How do we know that it's the same prayer?
¿Ustedes saben que es la misma oración?
Listen to this amazing story in the Talmud.
Escuchen esta historia muy increíble.
Recorded by Rabbi Yossi.
Que le escribió el rabino Yoshi.
It's going to be very long. I'm going to do it just in English for a moment. Okay. Recorded by Rabbi Yossi, the disciple of Rabbi Akiva, in the second century, less than 100 years after Yeshua. Listen to this. Next slide. It says, it was taught in the Beraita that King Yossi said, I was once walking along the road where I entered the ruins of an old abandoned building. Again, this is a second century story among the ruins of Jerusalem after the destruction in order to pray. I noticed that Elijah of blessed memory came and guarded where the entrance for me and waited at the entrance until I finished my prayer. When I finished praying, and exited the ruins, Elijah said to me, what is this word? Deferentially, as one would address a rabbi. Greeting to you, my rabbi. I answered him, greeting to you, my rabbi, my teacher. And Elijah said to me, my son, why did you enter this ruin? I said to him, in order to pray. And Elijah said to me, you should have prayed on the road. And I said to him, I was unable to pray along the road because I was afraid that I might be interrupted by travelers and would be unable to focus. Elijah said to me, you should have recited the abbreviate prayer instituted for such time as day or such circumstances. Next time, slide. Rabbi Yossi concluded at that time, from that brief exchange, I learned from him three things. I learned that one may not enter into a ruin. And I learned that one does not enter a building to pray, but he may pray along the road. And I learned to him that one who prays along the road recite the abbreviate so that may maintain his focus. And after this introduction, Elijah said to me, listen to this. Next slide. What voice did you hear in the ruin? I responded, I heard a heavenly voice, like an echo of the roar of the Holy One. Blessed be he, cooing like a dove and saying, woe to the children due to whose sins I destroyed my house, burned my temple and exiled them among the nation. And Elijah said to me, by your life and by your head, not only did that voice cry out in that moment, but it cried out three times each and every day, moreover, in time that God's greatness is invoked, such as when Israel enters synagogues and study halls and enters in what? And the Kaddish prayer, may the great name Hitgadal veHitkadash Shmerabah. Beloved, this is recorded in the second century. The notion that Yeshua would have not known this prayer is impossible. But here is the real shocker. The only Jewish text that we find this prayer in is the New Testament.
Esta oración es muy importante.
Y
es imposible que Yeshua no haya hecho esta oración.
Which leads me to this conclusion. Next slide. Yeshua knew the Kaddish, and the New Testament is the very first written form of the Kaddish prayer. So anybody who wants to say it is not a Jewish book going to have a problem with that.
Yeshua conocía el Kaddish, supo del Kaddish, y en el Nuevo Testamento es la primera versión de este Kaddish, de la oración del Kaddish.
Come on, get up there with your guitar. Come on, man. We're going to teach them how to do the Kaddish right now. Are you ready to learn?
Vamos a enseñarles cómo hacer
el Kaddish
en este momento.
We're running out of time, Shabbat is nearly out. And you know, we didn't decode the revelation yet. Way to know what God has to say about revelation in the Siddur, but I'm running out of time. We're going to have to leave that for next time. Oh, it's all in the Siddur. You're going to learn it. But stand up. I'm going to give you just a clue. The song of the Lamb.
Vamos a cantar la canción de la, del Cordero.
Revelation is in the Siddur. That's for later. Let's declare it. You got the Kaddish? You want the words? Can you go back to a slide, give him the words? We're going to teach you this. Maybe with Messiah, we're going to sing the word of the Kaddish. Thanks be to God that the New Testament is a Jewish book. And we have a Jewish rabbi. And we have a Jewish Messiah. Isn't it good to know that? How many of you are ready to learn those prayers? Can you do this Kaddish for us? Let's hear some of it. Come on. It's not on. Get him on. Here we go. Let it be light.
Here we go.
Let's do it.
This is a melody by Zusha. I hope some of you know the melody. Yitgadal, yitgadash, shmei rabba, be'alma divera chirute. V'yamlich malchutein. Again. Yitgadal v'yitgadash Shmei Rabba V'alma divirach yirutein V'yamlich malchutein V'yatz machbur kane V'karev meshiche V'yatz machbur kane V'karev meshiche
V'chayechon
V'yatz machbur kane V'karev meshiche V'yatz machbur kane
Come on, you're singing Yeshua. Here we go, we're going to teach him. Just play for a second. Say it with me. Keep on playing. Say it with me. We're going to learn it together. Are you ready? Say it with me. Itkadal. Ve'itkadash Shemeh Rabba Be'alma Devir Kirute Ve'yamlich Malchute Itzamach Purkane Ve'karev Yeshua. Here we go, listen to this. Here it's what it says. Here it is. May his great name be exalted and sanctified in the world which he made his will. May his kingdom reign, may his redemption sprout, and may he hasten the coming of Yeshua, our Messiah. Amen. Let's do it one more time. Now you know it. Yit Kadal. Come on, that's Yeshua.
Yit
Kadal. That's the Lord's Prayer, friends.
Yit Kadal. Shmei
Ve'alma. And Messiah is coming. Come on.
Karev Meshiche Ve'yatz Mach Purkane Ve'karev Meshiche Yit Kadal Ve'yit Kadash Shmeh.
This is the Lord's Prayer, beloved.
Be'alma Divrachirutei Ve'yamlich malchutze.
Hallelujah! We are singing the word of our Messiah.
Estamos cantando
straight
del
from
Mesías.
The prayer book. Isn't it awesome?
Junto con el,
isn't God is good?
El libro de oración. Dios es bueno.
Okay. I'm so sorry. No need for translation anymore. Thank you for Sarah. I don't know. Beloved, I'm sorry. I don't have time for Q&A. Because Shabbat is out or is coming out. And I don't want to monopolize all evening for you. I wanted to have a great evening. But it was the last prayer I wanted to decode with you. And I'll just give you a clue. Psalm 147. Revelation. It's all here. Get it today. Get all the resources. And welcome to the family of the house of Israel.